over here, white over here. Right there. White has won the toss and will receive. Shake, shake.
Good evening. Today is Friday, November the 28th, 2014, and you are watching the LHSAA Division IV football state semifinals live here at LouisianaAllAmericanSports.com. We are live here from Doug Williams Stadium. I'm Eric Hatfield, and I'm along with Gerard Piper as we are set to bring you this semifinal matchup. We are just underway here, and it's already some hard hitting. The crowds are fired up. This should be an excellent night for football. So third down now, third and 10, as the Chargers get the ball back to the original line of scrimmage. So first and 10, here come the Chargers up to the line of scrimmage. They are in the I formation. Sorry about that. We're having some connectivity challenges, but Southern Land picked up a first down, was penalized, and now has run the football. So it's fourth down, and the Chargers are forced to punt. It's kicked away. It's a high, high knuckler. It's coming deep, and it's going to bounce around the 25-yard line of the Kittens, where the home team, Southern Land, will take over first down and 10. And here come the Kittens onto the football field. I'm going to throw this damn computer out the window. First down, here come the Kittens. There's a handoff. We've said this name a lot, Darbyon Prophet, around the left side. And he's going to gain. We'll see where they spot it. No, we're wrong. We'll see where they spot the football. And Joker, if there's a whole dose of Darbyon Prophet, this could be very good news for the Kittens.
Very good news. That's what I came here to see, is Darbyon Prophet.
Yes, sir.
It's the state finals. The state semifinals. This is for to go to the big dance right here down in New Orleans. So very, very important game. The Kittens look like they're charged up tonight. They came out with a big hit on special teams right out the gate.
Veal in shotgun, checking with the sidelines. Drops back. And he steps up, pumps. Now he's wrapped up like a president's wrap. He is sacked by number four, Troy James, the sophomore. And that's a big loss for the Kittens. That's going to put them in third and long territory. And we'll see what Coach Mitchell's going to dial up.
That was a good defense right there. They didn't even have a strong pass rush, but that one guy was able to get in there and get Veal down. So great play on defense that time. Big play right there. It was going to bring up third down. Looks like about 20.
Yep. Third down, I'm just counting about 19 yards. So, yeah, we're warm. And there's a timeout. Another one. There's already been one timeout called, and now the Chargers have burned their first timeout. So this really is a chess match. They are really like two prize fighters punching and feeling each other out here early in the game.
Yeah, two early timeouts, which is, you know, pretty unusual at first, but I think, you know, they're going to be kind of cautious in this game. This is for to go to the big dance. So I think they're going to pull out all the stops right here. You got to leave everything on the field tonight.
It's for all the marbles. There's no saving it for next week.
Right.
And you can't take those timeouts with you into the second half either, for that matter. So I'm in full agreement. That's probably the proper strategy.
I think so too, especially on Madison Prep's part, because They know they may be a little bit undermatched tonight. And so even though it's third and 20, they still wanted to be able to try to stop the Kittens from making that first down so they can get the ball back.
And the Kittens have had explosiveness both running and throwing the football, even in tight situations like third down.
Well, let's see what they do here.
So here we go. Veal and shotgun. They have kind of a tight formation, although they are in shotgun. Twins left, twins right. Veal drops back to pass, steps up, five. It's caught, complete to Williams on the 20s. Oh, tries to put on a move. He's not going very far. Finally, hit, drop, brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down. They'll run Jannard Robinson up there to punt. The tackle made by number 11, Malcolm Roach. I'm just going to go out on a limb and assume he's related to Coach Roach, who is the coach of the Madison Prep Academy Chargers.
Yeah, probably his son. I think right there they probably played it a little bit conservative, trying to get the ball out to Curtin Williams. See if he can make a play, miss tackle or two, and be able to pick up the first down. So, good play call. I think it was pretty conservative, but hey, you know, you want to try to feel your way. Just kind of want to try to feel your way to see what you can do. And so they get the punt off, and looks like it's not going to be fielded. The Kittens are going to be able to corral the ball. It's like at the 37-yard line, so it's going to be first down and 10 for the Chargers. This is going to be their second possession.
So with about just over 7 minutes to go in the first period, rather, there's no score, and these two are just kind of feeling each other out here. We're going to take a very brief intermission. We'll be back in 30 seconds on Louisiana. So that's going to be first and long now as Madison Prep picks up yet another penalty. And I'll tell you, you're going to dig yourself in the hole very quickly on the road, especially against this defense if you dig up with a lot of penalties. Quarterback steps, fires. He goes long down the field, and he puts way, way too much on that one. I mean, I don't know who he thought he was hitting. I believe that was Edwin Kleinpeter, the quarterback. And he went long, and, well, that didn't work out so well.
No, that actually didn't work out too.
It'll pick it up on the recording. Yeah.
Right. That actually didn't work out too well, but the guy was open. The wide receiver actually was open, and he kind of overthrew him. I'm kind of getting confused. I see that actually number 12, Edwin Kleinpeter, is the quarterback
and
for the Cavaliers. And on second down and long, they try to hand the ball off up the field. Looks like it's going to be going to, is that Jaylen Brown?
I think so.
Number nine?
Yeah.
Yeah. And like you said, Eric, especially getting those penalties on the first down, a holding penalty, and to set you back to be first and 20, and that puts you in the hole, and those penalties are really almost like turnovers.
It stifles the momentum very, very badly. And Southern Lamb is now looking at third and a mile. I'm not that optimistic on them converting spread formation. Kleinpeter drops back, fires over the middle. It's tipped away by Dorian Welsh. That'll bring up fourth down.
Yeah, and that was almost picked off. It went right through his hands. Great defensive play that time. Southern was able to withstand Madison Prep that time. And, hey, now we get a chance to look at Derek Pate, see if he can maybe be able to break something here.
Oh, yeah, never a dull moment when Derek Pate's out on the field. This is definitely a young man who's worth the price of admission to see.
He's only 20 yards back.
There's the snap. Boots it away. It's a high knuckler. Pate calls for fair catch, and he will receive it at the 41-yard line where the Kittens will take over first and 10. So here's our time, guys. We've said this so many times before that this production is brought to you by the World Wide Web, and when the World Wide Web is not connecting well, we can't connect well. The twisting of the stores for knock on wood is should be the last
Highway's going to bounce in Madison Prep territory inside the 20, and that's a good job by the special teams. The kick, that ball is still rolling, and finally down the 12-yard line with Madison Prep will take over first and 10.
That was a good, it was trying to be a good thing. Yeah, now kids
players kicking the ball,
try to
kick it to the 12.
So that's what made the ball keep rolling. So they actually got it here at the 15.5-yard line. And it's going to be Madison Prep's third time with the ball this first quarter. Neither team has been able to really get a first down yet to be able to move the ball with any kind of success so far. But we'll see. It's going to be first.
Not surprised by it is a curve stomp. The Madison Prep got the cheap tip in 6-36. And anybody with any kind of pride is going to have a vengeance next to that humbling defeat on the mind, I'm sure.
Oh, most definitely.
And that was for their homecoming, too.
Yeah.
63-6 to get the district rival, the Southern Lab Kittens. So I'm sure their motivation is through the roof right now for this game. I don't think that score was reflected in the quality of the Madison team. But, you know, you are what your record is, and you are what the score, or, you know, the score is what it is. But that being said, I'm sure these kids are very, very motivated. Like I said, they've been under the law. Second down, 10 yards to go. Here comes the left side. That's going to carry by number 31. Talon Spurlock. We got a nice guy from Ferguson. And so Talon Spurlock picks up maybe about four on the play, and that's going to bring up 36.
Good play that time. They were able to get the ball outside a little bit. But speaking back on what you said, Eric, I mean, sometimes they motivate. We'll see if it works out. If it works out.
And Kleinpeter fires it. Oh, the front basket of the intended receiver
number 11, Malcolm White. So Dan's probably going to have something to say to him. He gets the sidelines, it's fourth down, and they'll be forced to run Braylon Bolden up to punt.
Yeah, and it actually was the same type of play that Southern kid, Mav Gittin, just had on the other side.
Right, Xavier Bell had one way down the field, bounced off his chest. I mean, it's pretty cool outside, and it's kind of moist in the air. That's not conducive for catching a lot of passes, at least in the deep. Oh, that's a terrible kick. In all fairness. So that's about a 9 yard, no, that's a 5 yard punt, no return. But in all fairness, you know, I don't, Bolden, I can't really block him though, if he had not given it that high trajectory. That was actually an adjustment on the fly. I think the failure wasn't on the punter. I think it was on the front line.
I think so too. I think he got a great jump on the ball. He was able to have the second line up. He came real close to blocking, so like he said, kick it out of the back, put the ball up, kind of kick it straight up in the air. That's almost a double for a turnover.
Quick adjustment. I'll tell you what, the plus 5 yards is better than minus 10 or touchdown.
Yeah.
I guess it's depending on how you look at it. There's the handoff. That'll be on profit right from there to the 20-yard line. And the Southern Baptist kick is going rolling like raw hat.
Yeah, that's going to be going.
One tackle, can't shake the second, and get a little chippy there, little hands on activity. We'll see how the fishes are going to count this one.
Get any type of momentum or get a sustained drive going, and we'll see how they do here. So it's first and 10.
And Klein Peter looks, fires to the sideline, is caught, complete to Malcolm Roach, and that's very close. That should be a first down by my calculations.
Yeah, first down right there. Roach was able to redeem himself on that time and was able to catch the ball. And from what I'm seeing so far, this guy, Klein Peter,
has a good arm.
He has a good arm, and he's pretty accurate. We've seen a couple of drop passes that they had by the receivers that cost him a first down. But I like what I'm seeing so far. This guy's pretty accurate.
Yeah, he's doing a good job of putting the football where it's supposed to be. First down, 10 yards to go. Football is at the 33-yard line of the Madison Prep Academy Chargers. There's the handoff around the left side, and doesn't go very far as Tawan Spurlock gets back to the line of scrimmage. No game.
No game right there. Man, the Sudden Lap Kitten's defensive line really standing up. I've seen maybe a fourth stops at the line of scrimmage and two, I think, for losses so far. So the defensive line is doing a great job so far. They're getting the push that they need.
Second and 10. We're under 2 minutes remaining in the first quarter. We still have no score yet. Here come the Kittens up to the line of scrimmage. There's the handoff, and I believe that's Spurlock, and he's wrapped up and dropped, and there's a flag down. There's a lot of extracurricular going on. I don't know if it was a downfield block or what, but that might be coming against that might be against the Kittens. That was an awfully physical confrontation, but we'll see what the men in stripes decide to call.
looks like it's going to be a holding call on the offense. And I think Nick Mitchell, Coach Nick, is going to be able to, probably going to decline this penalty.
You're spot on, spot on, spot on, Joker. That's going to bring up third and 10. So Madison Prep's run two plays, and they've managed to gain nothing.
That was a great call right there on the defense. That actually looked like a corner blitz. And number 20, Malcolm Hall, defensive back, was able to get in there almost the same time he handed the ball off to the running back. And he was able to stop him for a no gain.
So here come the Chargers back up to the line of scrimmage. Minute 31 to go in the first quarter. Third down. Spurlock, draw play. And number 20, Quincy Banks, comes around the right side. He's not even close. Actually, it wasn't a bad run. He picks up, oh, maybe five on the play, but that's not going to be enough. And I don't know if the ball came loose. There's a lot of lot of rambling and a lot of jockeying down there. And we'll see what the call is.
Real close, actually, the Southern Lab Kitten guy grabbed the running back at the same time he was going down, and both of them was grabbing onto the ball. So I think they was trying to fight for the ball, both teams. And actually, they gave the ball back to Madison Prep. So that's going to bring up fourth down. They're going to have to punt the ball once again.
Yep. So they're going to run Braylon Bolden out there to punt. Deep to receive is Derek Pate for the Kittens.
Uh-oh.
We all know what he can do there. Oh, that's a good kick that time. That's going to roll around the 30 and takes a good bounce. And actually, I think it worked out. Well, they got it to the 35-yard line, so good net on that play. And the Kittens will take over first and 10.
Had a good bounce that time off the kick, especially after coming off of the last kick that was only 5 yards, you know.
right.
Any improvement of that is a plus.
Yeah, I think that's a step in the right direction for the Chargers.
They actually got a good roll on there, so that's going to bring up first and 10. We're going to see if somebody can get a little bit of momentum going. It's been a defensive stand so
far.
Sure
is.
Both teams have been holding up their end of the bargain so far, so we're going to see who's going to be the first one to crack.
Beals in the shotgun. Drops back to throw. Fires to his left. It is, oh, another drop. Boy, it's been butterfingers tonight. As that pass was intended, I believe that's Joseph McWilliams. I'll wait till we get a better look at the jersey there.
Oh, that's actually Devin Dixon.
Yep, that's Dixon. So that is incomplete. And, boy, that's another drop pass that could have gone for a whole lot of yards.
Yes, indeed. And the way this game is going, you need all those opportunities. You have to be able to catch the ball a bit.
Right.
You can't do that in a type of game like this. You have to be able to step up.
Yeah, it's as simple as that. It's part of what you know you've been doing your whole life. Run, turn around, I'll throw it. Catch the ball.
Exactly.
If you don't do that, you're going to have problems. I believe that's a false start.
Yeah, another false start.
That hurts.
And just like we said, shooting yourself in the foot. So you go from actually dropping a pass, which would have been a first down for big yards, and to the next play, getting a false start. Now it's going to bag you up. It's going to bring up second and 15. And these are the type of things that the discipline and the fundamental comes into play. You know,
that's about a 30-yard swing.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly right. And those type of plays are equivalent to turnovers.
Yep.
So here we go, second and 15.
They're drive killers. Second down, 15 yards to go. Twins to the left, one receiver to the right. In motion is Prophet. Beal, there's the handoff right up the chute. And Prophet goes nowhere. It takes a... Oh, yeah, guys, you have Malcolm Roach jumping on the pile. And finally, that brought down the running back. Well, it took a whole heck of a lot to get it done, but it'll finally bring up third down. Darby on Prophet is hard to tackle.
Yes, indeed. Good running right there, man. He ran with a lot of power, and they still didn't get him down.
That was just a four-yard gain. I mean, that's the toughest four-yard run I think I've seen in quite some time. It took all 11 charges to bring him down.
To bring him down.
And I believe Madison, who's just called a timeout? That's the end of the quarter. So at the end of the first quarter, we have no score. You're watching... You're watching Southern Lab Football on Louisiana All-American Sports.com. So we're back to the action. Teams have switched sides, and we're in the second quarter. Beal, walking up to the line of scrimmage. Trips to the right. One receiver left. Beal fires, caught, Derek Pate, and that's a huge third down pass, Thursday! 25, 20, 15, 10, 30,
touchdowns, they're paid. Touchdown from the left. And there's a flag,
the flag on the field. Wait a minute, hold up. I don't know yet. I don't know what he could have called. Let's find out. I see the referees discussing it with each other. I'm going to find out what this call is right here.
That's a potential touchdown coming off the board. So
yes, indeed. I think we're good. I think it may be on the defense. Unsportsmanlike.
So it's just nothing more than unsportsmanlike. Reverend Richard might have let his plate get a little hot. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Kittens drawn first blood, 6-0 on a, that was a 68-yard, about a 68-yard reception for a touchdown by the playmaker, Derek P. Here come the Kittens out to attempt for two.
And here they go.
Rolling out, and is it good? And I don't see a signal yet. No. Looks like it's no good.
So, he came real close, man, because he fought for it.
Unfortunately, close only counts in horseshoes and hand grenades as the Southern Lab Kittens are up 6-0.
Man, that was an amazing play by Derrick Pate that time. He caught the ball out of the flat, and this guy just, I mean, turned on the jets. He hit the sideline, and the defense was out of position, but his speed was so fast that they would get to that corner, and he just hit that corner and was gone down the sideline.
It's like he had an overdrive mode there, Joker.
All the way to the house. Amazing play.
So after the unsportsmanlike penalty, the Kittens will be kicking off from midfield. Jannard Robinson's son, no, even deeper than that, they're going to kick off, I believe it's from the 45. It is from the 45.
Wow. Now, since the Kittens have struck first blood, we're going to see what the Madison Prep Chargers are going to do. See if they can come back with their own score. They've had the ball three different times in the first quarter and wasn't able to really move the ball. They had no momentum. And now I think this possession right here is pretty crucial for them, but they don't want to get down in the hole too much.
Yeah, they do not want to fall behind quickly to this team, as that didn't work out so well for the last go round. And that is going to put Madison Prep in some pretty deep field position situation there.
Yeah, so that penalty really hurt them by the Kittens being able to kick off the ball on their own on Madison Prep's 45-yard line. Now Madison has to start inside the 20 again. So it looks like the ball is going to be on the 15-yard line. It's going to be first and 10. And here comes Madison, and Clyde Peters, the quarterback. And he has Quincy Banks in the backfield with him. Yeah. First and 10, he hands the ball off to Banks. He goes right up the middle. And that's going to be about 5 yards out to the 20-yard line. Decent yardage. For first down, it's going to bring up second down and 5. Madison comes back up to the line of scrimmage, and second and 10. Clyde Peter looks to the sideline. He gets the call. They got twin receivers on both sides. He fakes the ball. He gets the ball back to Banks again, and the kid is corralling right as for no gain. He tried to hit the sidelines, but the defensive line was right there on him. So that's going to actually bring up third down now and 5, and this is a big down. But they don't want to actually give the ball back to the Kittens in good field position. So we're going to see what the Madison Preparatory Chargers are going to call this play. And here they come up to the line of scrimmage. Clyde Peter gets the call from the sideline. He has Quincy Banks to the flank of him. He gets the ball. It's a quarterback draw. He goes straight up the middle.
Oh.
And what a hit! Booyah!
Oh, Javon Ferguson just laid out.
Oh, my goodness. Don't kill him.
I think he got his wind knocked out.
Oh, yes, indeed.
But it wasn't in vain. It was, I guess he got the first down, but boy, that's...
Wow. Whew. Man, what a hit. And he gets up staggering a little bit. He looks a little drunk, but he's going to look like he's going to be okay. Well, actually, he's still down. That's the wrong player. He is still down on the field right now.
He got his wind knocked out good.
man, there's been some big hits out here already in this ball game. And we're going to hope this guy's going to be all right. This is actually their best player, the quarterback. He was at least able to get the first down. He got the ball out to all the way out to the 32-yard line.
Well, it's like they're having to scrape him up off the field. He is down. I think he got his wind knocked out. If you look at how the hit came, it was right in the chest. I think it literally knocked the air out of his lungs. He's just going to need a minute to get himself together there.
Yeah, I think so, Eric. I think that's what happened to him. You know, he's moving around a little bit, but he's still laying on his back. He got the trainers out there with him. And just like now, they're getting ready to pull him up, pick him up. And he's getting up on his own. And
That's a good job.
So. Well, they got to help him off the field now. So just maybe it looks like some type of leg.
Yeah, I thought maybe he just got the wind knocked out of him, but he's walking very gingerly. For the sake of Madison Prep, I hope that's just a tweak and he can walk it. He can get back on. I don't know. That doesn't look good.
That don't look good at all. He actually needs two trainers to help him on the sideline. Even one guy couldn't do it. And here we go. And this guy was doing pretty good tonight.
Oh, I mean, look at the run he had before he was injured. I mean, that you know, he salvaged the drive and got a big first down. But boy, Javon Ferguson just welcomed him to Doug Williams Stadium, I suppose. That was jarring.
Well, yeah, slobber knocker.
Yeah, that was a slobber knocker, all right.
Most definitely. So I guess they got the backup quarterback now. It looks like it's going to be Sharon Brumfield that's in the backfield for the Madison Prep.
And Sharon Brumfield, I believe, is probably related to Corey Brumfield who played at Brumfield launches a bomb down the field, and it is caught. It's caught on his feet to the 20, 15, to the 10. And look at that. Boy, oh, boy.
Touchdown.
Who says backup quarterbacks can't pick up where it left off? As Sharon Brumfield comes off the bench and launches a long bomb to Brian Savoie, and Madison Prep has tied the score at 6-0.
And just like that, one play, booyah, inside that box, in the end zone. Actually, that was a great play call right there. By bringing in the backup quarterback, you wouldn't think that they would actually go deep and try to go for the home run, but they did.
Right, you would think, just common conventional wisdom, that they think, okay, he's going to get his feet wet, maybe a short pass, a handoff. Oh, no, they came out with both guns a-blazing, and Brumfield was up to the task with a long bomb. That was a 67-yard touchdown pass from Sharon Brumfield to Brian Savoie. And now here come the Chargers out to attempt a two-point conversion.
Oh, and it.
The ball's loose. I think the ball is dead. I don't think you can recover it or return it. Either way, that conversion fails. But there is a flag on the play, and there's another flag, and they're getting a little testy there. And
looks like going to be a hit after the play, and a little bit of extracurricular activity.
A lot of extracurriculars, and I don't think we're talking about arts and crafts.
Yeah.
We're talking about pushing and shoving.
Oh, yeah, the boys will be boys.
Well, I can hear. I could hear all the way up from the press box. You might even be able to at home. Carl Patrick Ozan let out an S-bomb, and something went awry on that play.
Something went awry on the play. Actually, when they tried the two-point conversion, the snap wasn't a good snap, and it went over the quarterback's head. And so they were fighting for the ball, and I think it was actually a dead ball. And they kind of got into a little scrummage fighting for the ball, and that's kind of where it started.
So that is the kind of thing where if you are Coach Mitchell or Coach Holden, you want to scream. Because here it is, you kept the score tied, you've foiled the two-point conversion attempt of your opponent, and then you help them out by giving them 15 yards extra field position. And Madison Prep doesn't have that strong of a kicking game, so you've really helped them out. Now you're going to pin yourself deep. That is not the kind of play that's conducive to winning a state championship. That, as Rex Ryan would say, is a playing like a jackass. And you cannot play like a jackass and expect to beat a team like this in a situation like this.
Not at all, Eric. And you hit it right on the head. This team doesn't need any more momentum than they already have.
Right.
Their quarterback is out, and by you being able to give them that type of a foolish penalty like that and not holding, doing what you're supposed to do,
yeah,
it just gives them confidence. And you know what I mean? You can... And things like that can have a way of building.
Right, and two things that right now the Chargers don't need anymore, if from a Southern Lamp perspective, they don't need any more confidence and they don't need any more motivation.
Right. After getting beat like that earlier in the season by this team, their quarterback going down. But I give them kudos. The last play, actually, I saw that a defensive back he didn't judge the ball right, and he actually slipped down, and the receiver was ended up wide open, was able to catch the ball, and he had blockers. So it was a good play by the Chargers. But here we go with the kickoff.
So here they come up to the kicking off now from the Kitten's 45. And there's an endo, a knuckleball. That's a good kick right at the 5-yard line, fielded by Payne. Oh, my goodness gracious. He's at the 25. Third, they have to pull his head off to bring him down.
And that's going to be a penalty.
And you know what, though? If I'm the Madison Prep coach, that's okay. I'd rather have the ball at midfield than have Payne house that one, which he was on his way to do until they started grabbing all kinds of body parts.
You do what you can to stop that guy. Man, that was amazing. That guy leaped over a defender and was almost broke that one. That guy is amazingly fast.
I tell you, when he hits that extra gear, that is a wrap. That's Robert Dixon the third, but as I said, that just because that's a penalty doesn't mean that was a bad play.
Right, not at all.
Because I think he was going to go. Folks, we apologize at home. We have a loose internet connection, and it's going to cut in and out for a little while. We do apologize. We're working to rectify that, but stay with us. You can always follow the game on the graphic interface to keep up with what's going on. We're keeping that updated, and we're doing the best we can to bring this to you on LouisianaAllAmericanSports.com. Just over 10 minutes remaining in the period. Veal and shotgun. It's a tight formation. Twins left, twins right. Veal moving folks around. 3 seconds on the play clock. Peyton motion. He's coming on a jet sweep, a slow jet sweep. It goes around the left side, and actually he's going to be dropped for a loss. And you want to talk about people that need motivation. Remember, Derek Pate played for the Madison Prep Academy Chargers in his freshman and sophomore seasons before transferring to Southern Lab last year. So I'm sure he would love nothing more than to go to the state championship game at the expense of his old team.
Yeah, I know he probably has a lot of motivation to be able to stick it to his old team. And I think by his big play ability, them trying to get the ball to him. I don't mind the play call. It was a good play call.
You got to take some chances.
Yeah.
I don't think he was aware of his assignment. If you notice, Veal was motioning very quickly as the play clock was running out. I don't think he was up to par on the play call. Veal rolling out, fires over to the sideline. Xavier Bell didn't drop that one. He's to the 30. He's to the 25 and finally run out of bounds. Just short of the 20-yard line. And so Xavier Bell, who dropped the pass earlier in the game, makes up for that one. As that, we'll see where the ball is spotted.
Looks like the ball is going to be on the
26-yard line. So that is a 28-yard reception, and they are in enemy territory now, are the Southern Lab Kittens.
Great call right there. The quarterback, Bill, was very, very poised in the pocket and kept his eyes downfield and was able to get to the receiver. And there he goes, Darby Young Prophet, right up the middle.
And once again, they're making him work hard there. Second down.
It's going to be second down. He got 6 yards on there. It's going to be about second out, about five.
Yeah, that's a good game. That's a good run by Prophet. It's like, you know, he could just run into the wall. They just can't find a way to stop him.
Exactly. They only have given the ball, I think, 3 times so far.
There's a man down, player down.
Yeah, we got a Charger that's down on the field. Looks like he's limping off. That'll be number 50.
He's coming off, and I'm going to reduce the bandwidth again. So we're back to the action. Again, we apologize for the stop and go. We can't control the internet, folks. it is brought to you wirelessly, but we are keeping you up to date as best we can. So we have a false start against the Kittens, and that's going to move it on back. And so it's going to be – actually, all the good yardage now was just lost on that penalty. And, boy, I don't know how many times we can say it. I mean, these things will kill you. They've got to clean that up. Veal fires. End zone. Incomplete.
A little bit too much mustard again.
Yeah, I'll tell you, there's enough of some soft pretzels right now tonight.
I think he just needs to calm down a little bit, settle in a little bit in the pocket, and take his time. The receivers are actually open. He's just putting a little bit too much mustard on.
He just takes another fraction of a second longer. He has not been under a lot of duress. He hasn't gotten a whole lot of pressure. So just take a little longer before releasing that ball.
But here we go. It's going to be third down and 9 again. To get a ball to Prophet on the sweep. He cuts back. Cuts to the inside.
All the way down inside the 9. First and goal.
Great run right there by Darby on Prophet. I think they're going to probably start using him a little bit more. They haven't been using him. They've been kind of passing the ball a little bit.
Yeah.
Pate has been real big. Has made a couple of big plays so far. And to me, that's a good thing. But here we go, first and 10.
Ball is at the 9-yard line. First and goal.
There he is, Jarvis Prophet, right up the middle.
And he gained maybe 3 on the play. So they were waiting for him that time.
Yeah, they was waiting for him. They get it all the way down to the 6-yard line, so it'll be second and goal.
I'm guessing about the 6, it looks like.
Yeah, 6-yard line.
He is just such a hard runner. So, Veal calling the signals. There's the draw play. Prophet. Oh, he gets upended. And the ball is loose, and the Chargers recover it. Oh, boy, that was a fantastic play. The tackle and the fumble recovery were made by number 8. And actually, that should not be a fumble. That was Everett Richard with the tackle, but actually the ball popped loose after Prophet went end over end and hit the ground.
Yeah. So it's kind of close. Prophet took a big hit right there. He's kind of limping off the field pretty gingerly, but I think he got hit maybe in the wrist or in the hip. Hopefully he'll be okay.
Shotgun formation.
They called the ball down.
Yeah, when he hit the ground, they said it was down. It didn't,
right.
And then there's an encroachment.
Ground can't cause a fumble, right?
That'll be half the distance, so instead of third and goal from the 8, it'll be third and goal from the 4. So here come the Kittens back up to the line of scrimmage. Veal. High snap, floats a fade to the end zone. It's interference. That's going to be another third down and another half the distance to the goal as the pass was intended, I believe, for Tevis Abraham, and the Chargers defender was draped on him like a cheap suit. I believe for the Chargers that was Tyrese Walker. I can't see his number too well from here.
Yeah, that was Tyrese Walker, number 10. And a big, big penalty right there. Big call right there.
So they've gone from third and goal to 8 to third and goal to 2. Now, the second penalty, I think, was a wise one. You know, if it's that close and it's not an automatic first down like in college or the pros, why not pull him?
Wow.
Why let him catch it? It's a 2-yard penalty.
Wow. Well, I totally agree. I thought it was automatic first down, so pardon me. But so that actually wasn't a bad play at all.
It actually came as a surprise to me since I've been doing this. I learned that a few years ago. In high school football, Louisiana high school football, there are only 2 penalties that results in an automatic first down. Unsportsmanlike conduct and a personal foul. Anything else, if the yards don't get you there, it's not a first down. So, you know, if it's third and 30, you know, and somebody interferes and it's a... And they're close. There's the handoff right up the middle.
Referee puts up 4th down signal, so it's going to be a big call here.
So they didn't get it.
They didn't get in. They're inside the 1-yard line.
So we're 4th and goal at the 1.
4th and goal at the 1. We're going to see if they got Joseph McWilliams in. Southern rushes back up to the line.
There they go. I formation. I believe that's Javon Ferguson and Joseph McWilliams. Ferguson is a bull of a lead blocker, so we'll see what they're going to do there. And Blagerville calls timeout. Very mature decision. Don't rush it. You can't take the timeouts with you. You've got to get this right. You've got to get the lead here.
I thought maybe they was trying to maybe get him to come outside that time he wanted to break and see what how the defense would look. And great timeout right there. Now they can come back and be able to. But they're right there. It's 4th and, I mean, inches. They're inside the 1.
So we have 6 minutes, 16 seconds to go in the half. I'd like to remind you that tomorrow morning you can listen to the Louisiana All-American Sports Show on 96.9 FM WHYR, Baton Rouge Community Radio. We are a low-power station, but if you cannot pick up the... Can I pick up the broadcast signal? Hey, no problem. You can pick us up from anywhere in the world at WHYR.org on the live streaming.
Yeah, boy.
Yep. So here they come back up to the line of scrimmage.
Oh, yeah. Big possession right here. I think they want to be able to get inside the end zone so they can get a comfortable lead.
It's a triple wing formation. There's Javon Ferguson, Joseph McWilliams.
That's quarterback sneak.
And... That's exactly what they tried. I don't think it worked.
And he didn't get it. Loose. He didn't get it.
Not only is it a turnover on downs, it's a fumble. So that's a wrap, and the score is still tied at 6-6. You're watching Southern Lab Kittens Football on LouisianaAllAmericanSports.com.
Yeah, boy.
6-12 to go in the period.
Big play right there.
That was a huge defensive
huge
thing.
Play. Be able to drive down the field and come out with nothing. But they're backed up in their own end zone inside the 1 yard line. Their quarterback is out, so we're going to see what they're going to run right here. This would be a good time to be able to get a safety if they try to run the ball. And here we go.
Right up the middle. And he goes nowhere. Stopped the eight. I might even have lost a yard. So that'll bring up second and long.
It'll be second and long. That's why I don't fault Coach Mitchell for going for it on fourth down, because if your defense has been playing real well so far, even though the score is tied, they got that one big play down the field. But other than that, the defensive line has been pretty good. They've been stopping the run pretty good. And so I don't mind them going for the fourth down, not making it, because now they got them pinned down on their own, inside their own, looks like 2 yard line now. So
the range of plays they can try is limited. It's not a pass is a high risk play, because if it breaks down, if there's a sack, it could, you know, can put points on the board for the opponent. So, I think it was a low risk and possible high reward proposition. I don't blame them for going for it.
Right. And get the ball in good field position. They're able to get them to stop them here. So, here we go. Second down.
Looks like they're going to blitz. They do. And looks like the Chargers will just barely get back to the line. They might even have lost a yard. We'll see where they spot the football. No gain, so it brings up third and 10.
Be third and 10. I think they're trying to go conservative. Actually, right here, we're going to see what they're going to do. They're going to try to run the ball again. They haven't been able to get anything so far with the two runs that they tried to do right up the middle, right into the heart of the defensive line. So we'll see what they're going to do here. Are they going to attempt to pass it being third down and 10, deep in their own territory in the second quarter?
So, Sherrod Brumfield under center. The last pass he threw was a pretty good one. We'll see what they dial up this time. And there's another flag on the play. That's going to be delay of game. The bad news is it's half the distance to the goal. The good news is the ball was at the 2, so that's a 1 yard penalty.
Not bad. He actually turned around and looked at the play clock. Oh, they actually got a timeout in. Coach got a timeout in before the penalty. So
that'll be third and 10 again. We have 5:21 remaining in the half.
Each team has what, one timeout left?
One timeout remaining. They have definitely utilized those timeouts. They know you can't take it with them, and this is a game of strategy. So everyone is pulling. They're leaving it all on the field. They're leaving every weapon. They're taking every weapon they have available out of their bag. They know there's no next week if you don't win this game.
And if I was Coach Roach, I would take the points right now that I have. 6-6 in the second quarter. And if he thought that he would be in the game, and you told him that the score was going to be 6-6 in the second quarter, almost going to halftime, I think he would take it.
I agree. Yeah, that, especially considering the last go-round.
Right, exactly. So they're still in it.
Backed all the way up to the 2 yard line. Third down and long. And somebody moved. That will be a false start, and that will be half the distance. But as I said, big deal.
Well, the offensive, actually, that was defense encroachment. And that's, they're going to actually give them 5 yards.
Oh, that's a big difference. Didn't see that. I thought I'd seen the Chargers move. That 5 yard penalty is going to give them some breathing room.
Give them some breathing room.
And exactly. Now they can attempt to pass. That's a costly penalty. That's a silly penalty by the Kittens. The mental errors are really keeping this team from opening it up here in the second quarter. And Brumfield fires up a prayer. It's caught, complete. It's to the running back, and he's going to have a first down. And that is how penalties kill you. If it is third down and long at the 2, I'm pretty sure Madison Prep is going to run the ball, cut their losses, and try to get out there. Instead, they put some pressure on Brumfield. He very alertly saw Quincy Banks, and Banks with a nice run all the way up to the 21-yard line for a first down. So that's a 14-yard gain, and now the Madison Prep Academy Chargers are in business.
And great awareness right there by Brumfield. He was under a little bit of duress, and he was able to throw the ball out in the flat to Banks, and he was scattered on up for the first down, and big, big play right there. They get the ball to Banks again. He goes to the outside for no gain. Actually, it looked like he may have lost a yard to the 20-yard line.
Yeah, I think he got dropped for a loss of one, Joker.
But they had those guys pinned down there. Like you said, it was a lot of mental errors that the kids had with penalties, blown assignments so
costly
far.
Costly ones, too. I mean, big ones. You know, I mean, it's not like a little 5 yards here and there. Those 5 yards led to a first down. Some of the drop passes combined with penalties have had 30-yard swings. I mean, the Kittens are their own worst enemy right now.
And they're kind of shooting themselves in the foot. This actually is going to take a lot more time off the clock. They could have got the ball back in good field position.
Right, with a chance to go ahead.
To go ahead.
And really, that opportunity has now been turned over to the Chargers. They're the team with a chance to make something out of this half. There's the handoff. I believe that's Quincy Banks. And he doesn't go anywhere. He might have lost a yard.
They're going to bring up third down. He lost a yard.
He sure did.
Ball's at the 19-yard line. And it's going to be third and 12.
Third down, 12 yards to go.
But the way this guy's been passing, who knows?
Yeah, I mean, they've got some quarterback talent because I was impressed with Edwin Kleinpeter. He had a rifle for an arm.
Right.
This kid wasn't bad. Now, he threw it down the field. It was a little wobbly, but, hey, he hit his man. He got some strength.
He was one for one with a touchdown.
That's right. And then you have the second pass out to Banks on third down. So the two passes that have left his hands, good things have happened. And they're trying to hurry, and that's a delay of game. I don't think the Chargers got the timeout. We'll see. Nope, Madison Prep, they've used their third and final timeout with 3 minutes and 26 seconds remaining in the first half. The score is tied at 6. You're watching Southern Lab Kittens football on LouisianaAllAmericanSports.com.
Yeah, boy. Good time to call your timeout right there. Your third down. You know you want to try to keep the chains rolling and see if you can get some momentum. And why not use it there?
Yeah, take it with you.
To keep the 5 yards from getting the 5 yard penalty. So
yeah, I mean, you know, third and 12 is a heck of a lot more makeable than third and 17. And if you don't get it, you're probably not going to get possession again anyway and not be able to really use that timeout. So I think it was the right decision. And here we go. It is a third down. Twins to the left, one receiver right, and Brumfield flips it and is dropped. What did you see on that play, Joker?
I saw two receivers on the near side. One was only covered, and then both of them went out, and actually that guy was wide open. If Brumfield would have saw him to the right with the arm that he has and put it out there, I mean, who knows?
I think there are two things that can explain that. Let's assume it wasn't a mental lapse. It could have been a zone coverage. And also, right, the pressure I noticed, you had a strong side blitz coming from that side. So they were flushing the quarterback to his right. That would have been really hard for him to throw it to his left. Perhaps.
Ooh. Almost blocked that punt.
A wobbler of a kick. Oh, stay away from that. Stay away from that. Southern Lab almost touched it. It's down by Malcolm Roach at the 48-yard line after Braylon Bolden launched a nice kick, actually. Got a good kick, got a good leg for a freshman.
Yeah.
And ball's at the 49-yard line. That's where the Kittens will take over, first and 10.
First and 10. They got 3 minutes, 11 seconds left. They got the ball all the way down inside the one on their last possession and made a couple of mental errors, but they finally on defense held, so they got the ball back with a chance to try to go ahead before halftime.
So here come the Kittens up to the line. Bladrick Veal in the shotgun. Approaching 3 minutes to go in the half. Twins left, trips left, Twins right. Darion Prophet up the middle. Gains about 3 on the play. He'll be hit and dropped at the 48-yard line, second and 7.
Second and 7. And I think they'll probably be not too much in a hurry. You don't want to give the Chargers any time left. So we're going to see how they're going to manage this drive. They got the ball past midfield now. And just take your time and execute the play.
Ball at the 48, second and 7. Veal checking with the sideline. He steps back up to the line. And, high snap. Fires into the flat. It's caught complete to Mick Williams, and he gets out of bounds, and he's going to have the first down. That was a good catch and throw. Good adjustment by Kirtland. I saw him, he said Mick Williams. That was Kirtland Williams.
Yeah.
Not to be confused with his teammate, Joseph Mick Williams, number 6. My fault.
Good play that time because the quarterback was able, the bad snap was to his left. He was able to corral it in and look at receiver on the outside and get the ball to him. The receiver actually paused a little bit, but he was able to finally get up to the first down marker and get out of bounds. So now we're going to be what? First and 10?
Actually, I see third down on the dial-a-down. He must have been just short.
He was
like inches. And Prophet, he just picked up those inches. That's a first down. Still on his feet is Darby and Prophet, and finally brought down. I thought that was a first. You can see the dial-a-down and the first down marker are practically next to each other. So I thought he had it, but Hey, it doesn't matter now. It's all moot as it's first down deep inside Madison Prep territory.
Yeah.
2:19 to go now in the period. Ball is at the 28-yard line as the Kittens are starting to knock on the door yet again.
Yet again, they're doing pretty good. We got first and 10. Once again, the 28-yard line, they're moving the ball.
And another high snap. They got to work on that. Prophet through the B gap around the left side, and picks up a couple on the play. He's got good vision.
Yeah, he got good vision. He's starting to warm up a little bit now. The offensive line is starting to push the guys off the ball a little bit, open up a little bit of daylight for Prophet. And he's starting to gain them yards little by little. And here they go.
That was a 4-yard gain on the play. Beal to the end zone.
Touchdown! Perfect pass that time.
A 24-yard pass from Bladrick Beal to Xavier Bell. And the Southern Lab Kittens have regained the lead 12-6 with just over 2 minutes remaining in the half. What a play.
Great call right there.
I think the entire Charger front seven was dialed up for the run. The play action was just right, and boy, the Beal just put the ball right on the money, and the Kittens have regained the lead.
Right on the money that time. Beal had excellent vision, and he was able to see the receiver, and he said, just like you said, just wait a couple of more seconds, let the receiver be able to get a little bit of separation, and he saw the receiver that time, and was able to put the ball right on the money. Looks like Davion Prophet tried for the two-point conversion and was stopped short.
So that conversion fails the score. The Southern Lab Kittens leading the Madison Prep Chargers in the Division IV LHSAA State Semifinal 12-6. You're watching Southern Lab Kittens football on LouisianaAllAmericanSports.com.
Yeah, boy. So now we're under 2 minutes. Great drive right there. They got the ball right at midfield. Was able to go right down, make some big plays by the run game and the pass game on that drive, and was able to get the ball into the end zone.
That was a great drive. That really is the kind of drive that can test the constitution of a team in this situation, and the Kittens answered the bell very well. Now we'll see what the Chargers have. We know they have a little something in their bag of weapons. This is a capable team. I think, again, the next game I coach will be my first, but I think you let Sherrod Brumfield throw the ball a little bit more.
I think so, too. That was a great call right there, Eric, because this guy actually, the two times that he thrown the ball, he looked it pretty good. He was very aware. He got one big play for a touchdown, another one for a first down. So we'll see what they'll do on this possession. But I was very impressed by Southern.
Gerard Robinson kicks it deep. It's fielded, and there's a seam. Stabloff still on his feet.
Here he goes.
He's to the 50. He's to the 40, and Brian Stabloff brought all the way down at about the 37-yard line. That was
that's just what they needed. No flags.
That is what the doctor ordered. They're going to spot it at the 35. That's a 50-yard kickoff return by Brian Stabloff in the final 2 minutes of this half.
Another mental error by the Southern Lab Kittens special teams. You do a big play, and that's the last thing that you want to get that offense to come out with a big kickoff run like that all the way into your territory.
That could not. They're going to move back to the 36. That's a 49-yard return. Nonetheless, they have got Madison Prep is knocking on the door yet again as they are going to try to match Southern Lab's last touchdown and tie this score. Ball is at the 36-yard line. In motion is Savoy. Brumfield drops back to throw as comes the pressure. It's caught. It's complete to London Rush to the 15, to the 10, to the 5.
Touchdown!
Did Williams get it?
Yes, he got it.
He got it. Touchdown.
Touchdown. Did you see that pass?
That was a fantastic pass. And like I said, so far, every time this ball's left his hand, something good has happened. And that is continuing.
This guy's 3 for 3.
That is a 26-yard touchdown. I'm sorry, 36-yard touchdown pass from Sherrod Brumfield to Lyndon Rash, and he just put a rash on the hides of the Southern Lab Kittens as we're tied again. Joker, this is interesting and unusual at the same time.
Yeah, it is. I don't know how to call it, man. I'm talking about almost like a Drew Bledsoe, Tom Brady thing, you know. Bringing this guy Brumfield.
That's chipping away at my fan right there, Joker. That's a ridiculously high snap over the head of Roach. And that's going to be snuffed out by the Kittens. The ball's picked up by Trey Epps. That conversion fails, and that in the second quarter, With a minute and 31 seconds remaining, the score is tied up at 12 between the Madison Prep Academy Chargers and Southern Lab Kittens. You are watching Southern Lab Kittens football on LouisianaAllAmericanSports.com.
Yeah, boy. Yeah, boy, man, it's been big plays.
This has been an interesting first half.
These Madison Academy Chargers are fighting, man, and they really could have took the lead, actually, with the two-point conversion. Both of them had bad snaps.
Back to the action and ready for this second half as it is anybody's ball game. We're all tied up at 12. The Madison Prep Academy Chargers are set to kick off to the Southern Lab Kittens as Braylon Bolden is setting up on the tee, and this should be an exciting conclusion in this second half of this Division IV LHSAA quarterfinal game. Joker, as we said right before the half, this has been a matter of Madison Prep shooting themselves in the foot. Strike that. Southern Lab shooting themselves in the foot, and Madison Prep capitalizing at every opportunity.
Exactly. They capitalized off some of the mistakes and mental errors that the Kittens have made. And we're going to see how the second half is going to turn out. So here we go, second half.
And looks
gets the ball all the way out to the 42-yard line. I think that was Joseph McWilliams.
Looks like him. I think so. I didn't get a good look, but I believe that's where McWilliams would have been positioned. It wasn't on Pate's side of the field. And that will bring the ball up to the 40-yard line where the Kittens will take over first and 10. So they'll have some favorable field position to start the second half. And like I said, it's really, you know, the Kittens only have one person or one set of people to look at, and that's the men in the mirror as to how this game's going to go. This is still, I think, their ball game to lose in spite of the score.
I do too. And I think this half, I think Coach Mitchell is going to give them a good dose of profit.
Yeah. Yep. And there is the prophet around the right side, and he's going to push it all the way to the 45. Once again, he has hordes of tacklers hanging on him like a cheap suit filled with moths. But he still gets 4 yards. They made contact with him about 1 yard past the line of scrimmage.
Man, you know, this guy shows me a raw power. He's not a big guy, but he has tremendous leg drive, and he has a will.
And that vision, man, he can see those holes
exactly
really well. And he seems to have gotten better as the year's worn on. Veal and shotgun, second and six. Veal, hands off, Prophet through the B gap, and he didn't get very far. I don't think he gained anything, maybe 1 yard, and that'll bring up third and five.
Third and five, it looks like they're trying to go with Prophet. But I wouldn't run the same play or the same area all the time. I would try to give him a little bit of space.
Oh, you're right on with that, man, because clearly the Madison Prep Chargers are not as susceptible to being run over by Prophet as we've seen other schools. They're a little tougher in tackling it on defense. Shotgun formation. And we have a whistle.
Here we go. Looks like a false start. So they come right out of halftime. First possession, third and five, and it's going to back them up five. Now it's going to bring up third and 10, so which puts them in a more critical situation.
Yeah, that's now the few yards they've had to battle for just to scrape and scratch those 5 yards, Joker. They just lost it just like another example. I mean, it's, you know, I don't want to keep beating a dead horse, but it's penalties are killing them. That's going to be the undoing of this season if they don't get it straightened out. Veal, he's wrapped up like a president's sack. Good job by Malcolm Roach. He saw the seam. Nobody saw him coming on the weak side blitz, and that's going to bring up fourth down. Jannard Robinson should be coming on to punt.
And that's exactly what that 5 yard penalty does. It puts you in a situation where you have to pass, and the defensive strategy is then going to be pressure. And they got that weak side blitz, and he was able to come right in there and get Veal for the sack. So we're going to bring up fourth down.
Robinson kicks it away. Nice kick. It's gonna bounce in Charger territory. They'll wrap it up right there. It looks like it's gonna be at the 30. We'll see where they spot it.
Looks like
at the 34-yard line. It looks like.
Yeah, it looks like about the 33-yard line.
Let's see where they're standing.
Let's see where. At the 34.
So that's where the Chargers will take over, first and 10. With a score tied at 12, you're watching Southern Lab Kittens Football on LouisianaAllAmericanSports.com.
Yeah, boy. Now let's see what Madison Prep's going
to
do.
And now, now Madison Prep has a chance to really seize the reins right now. There's the handoff. They're going to give it. I believe that's Spurlock. We'll see when he gets up. He gets nothing. Yep, that was Tawan Spurlock, and that's going to bring up second down. He lost 2 yards on the play.
Good defensive play right there. Coming out of the break, the defensive line was able to get penetration and get him for a loss. So it's going to bring up second down and 12. Another
really
pass situation.
Yeah, they hit those gaps hard, Joker. I mean, they really did. That was on a four-man rush. I don't believe I saw any blitzing linebackers.
The defensive line has been doing a pretty good job, I can say, so far this game. So they look pretty good.
We've watched their front four all year get pressure on the opposing quarterbacks, and they're doing it again. Again, a four-man rush, and he puts one up, and it's caught by a parent, apparently, on one. Great catch.
Good catch, Mom.
Sign that man up.
Yeah.
See if he has any eligibility left.
Well, that's the way you throw the ball away. You throw it all the way into the audience.
Well, he threw it away like it was a Mardi Gras present. Yeah, Carnival. Yeah. Carnival's not for another 2 months, man. Gotta save that. There ain't time to get on a float yet.
But so, he saved the sack.
And that's all that counts. Here we go now. Second down. He did a good job of getting out of the pocket, too. That was good pocket awareness. I'm really impressed with Sherrod Brown.
Yeah, third down.
Third down, twins left, twins right. Third down, 12 yards to go. Dropping back to throw is Brumfield. He's under pressure. Another four-man rush. He's going low. He throws. Yeah! Oh, no. The hands of Joseph McWilliams. But that's okay. Look, it brings up fourth down. The Chargers are going to have to run Braylon Bolden out to punt. And had he picked it off, it would have had about the same effect of field position as a punt. No harm there. Great play by McWilliams. It saves a potential touchdown.
It actually saves a potential touchdown. It also, they make it, with the way they've been punting the ball, they may get the ball even in better field position than with that interception.
Well, not only that, they're going to have to kick it to Derek Pink.
Right,
so.
Right, exactly.
I don't know, Piper, except for that five-yard catastrophe, which I think was a result of the near block, I thought Bolden's done a good job punting the ball. That one takes a bounce, a Chargers bounce. It's going to keep on rolling, trickling on down. Oh, man, great.
Wow.
That's all the way down. Well, Joker, I guess it did work out for the Chargers. They got it at the 25-yard line. Great kick. Good presence of mind. Roach downs it at the 25. Little takeover, first and 10. That was, wow. That was a 43-yard punt, no return. That's a pretty good net, especially for a high school kicker, especially for a freshman.
Yeah, especially for a freshman. Great punt. So the Kittens will get the ball. It's their second possession of the second half. They got twin receivers on both sides of the ball.
Shotgun formation. Veal. Boy, somebody moved. That was way too soon.
Another false start.
Oh, these are the kinds of things that drive a coaching staff insane. And that's against number 71, Chad Smith Jr. And I'll tell you, that's a big kid. When he moves, he's not going to get away with it. You'll see him move.
You're going to see him
move. That's a whole lot of movement.
Yeah, but another mental error, and it's going to bring him back. It's going to push him back to make it first and 15.
Oh, this is good. First down, 15 yards to go. Ball's at the 20-yard line. We'll correct your screen at home.
Derek Pate.
Caught, and there's Derek Pate. Hit and stayed on his feet.
Derek
Pate's not a big guy. He just picked up 13 yards in that play. He got popped and stayed on his feet.
Good effort. Way to get him out of the hole. They needed that play right there. It's going to bring up second down and looks like about 2 or 3 yards.
Yep, you're right. Second and three. And second and two, to the 34-yard line. You're right.
Yeah, so that was a great play right there. Bradley Veal loose on the sideline to get the play. They got twin receivers again in the spread formation.
Let's see what they're going to dial up here. In the shotgun, and Madison Prep is blitzing. They tried the weak side blitz, and there goes the Prophet, and bam. The Prophet is money with that first down, and the Kittens, who were in a little bit of a pickle after the penalty, have moved the sticks. First and 10.
Good job to be able to recover from the mental error they made earlier and get the first down. With a mixture right there. One nice pass to Derek Payton, another big run right there by Darvion Prophet. It's going to be first and 10. The ball is on the 36-yard line.
Trips to the right, one receiver left. There's the handoff. Prophet around the left tackle. Still on his feet, broke another tackle. And once again, he was hit right at the line of scrimmage. He shook the tackle off and picked up five. He has been doing this over and over and over again. And the Chargers had had some success bottling him up a little bit. Not lately.
He seems to be getting stronger as the game goes on. And this is the game plan you want. You know, you can get second and five or third and four, third and three. Those are pretty easy first downs to be able to pick up than to be in a passing situation where you're predictable. So this is the game plan that Coach Nick Mitchell wants to run, and it's working so far in the second half.
Shotgun formation. Veal. 3 seconds on the play clock. Drops back. Floats one up along the sideline. He caught it.
Great catch. Great pass right there.
Is there a flag? No, there's no flag. Great catch, though, and that's going to move the sticks, and they're going to move now into Madison Prep territory.
Yeah, and that ball was caught by Abraham, number 10. Great catch right there, but I liked where he placed the pass for the receiver right to be there. Able to to get the ball and get up and get it. He had a couple overpasses early in the game, but he seemed to settle down a little bit with the touchdown pass, and now he seemed to be a pretty accurate on his passes so far.
Tevis Abraham has made some tough clutch catches all year, and he seems to favor that fade route. Prophet round the left side, still on his feet, driven out of bounds. He maybe picks up.
He gets about 3-4 yards.
I don't like that spot, Joker. I thought he got a little more than that.
Me too. I thought forward progress. He actually, they only gave him 2 yards on that one.
Boy, well, I guess something's better than nothing. I think that's a bad spot.
I think it was a bad spot too. He looked like to be at least got 4 yards on there, to me. But hey, I'm not down there. I don't have the zebra shirt on, so
it's the holiday season. It's a season of giving. You should be being a wrench and pinching yards.
Right. Game. Well, I guess he's giving to the
Chargers.
To the Chargers. There you go.
Veal under pressure. Veal? Plenty of times. He loses the football. Falls back on it. Boy, that could have been bad. The ref, you saw him throw the marker down around the 48-yard line, but Veal had the presence of mind to pounce back on it. And they're going to move that ball to the 39-yard line. He lost a yard, but 39 is better than a turnover.
Yeah.
The ball just slipped out of his hand.
He wasn't paying attention to it. And the ball kind of got away from him. It's kind of cold out there.
Mm-hmm.
Hands are cold. He's not wearing gloves.
Yeah.
Right, so.
Third down, 9 yards to go. Veal looking to the sideline. We're in the third quarter, tied at 12. Twins to the left, twins to the right. The lone setback is Prophet. Looks like they're coming with a weak side blitz, and they do. Here comes Roach. Fires Veal downfield. Nice catch by Derek Pate. He kept his eyes on that ball. That was a textbook catch. Put his hands out. Caught that ball right in the palm, in the cup of his hands. First down, Southern Lamb.
And Derek Pate is starting to heat up right here in the second half. There's been a couple of big plays he's made so far. He's made the big run. And a couple of big catches right here. So, hey, the kids are on the move.
And Madison Prep has burned their first time out of the second half. So, with we have with 5:19 to go in the third quarter, we're tied at 12. You're watching Southern Lab Kittens football on LouisianaAllAmericanSports.com.
Yeah, boy.
So I'd like to remind you to join us tomorrow morning, Saturday, at 11 a.m. for the Louisiana All-American Sports Show on 96.9 FM WHYR, Baton Rouge Community Radio. We'll be discussing this game and others in high school action. We'll be discussing the final week of the regular season in college and the bowl picture. And, of course, we'll be talking about the Saints, who have Forrest Gumped their way into still being tied for first place in the NFC South. All that and more on Louisiana All-American Sports, Saturday mornings, 11 a.m. on 96.9 FM in Baton Rouge, or from anywhere in the world at WHYR.org. So here come the Kittens. They're knocking on the door. Ball's at the 28-yard line. Veal checking with the sideline. Play clock has started. Coming up on 5 minutes to go in the quarter. Trips to the left. One receiver to the right. Veal calls for the ball. Steps up. He has a blitz coming from the strong side. Close one. Derek Pate hands on. Yes. Touchdown, Derek Pate.
Touchdown, Derek Pate.
A 28-yard touchdown pass from Gladrick Veal to Derek Pate. And the Southern Lab Kittens have regained the lead 18-12.
Yeah, boy, man, what a catch that time by Derek Pate. It's the second catch in a row. He was able to catch the ball with his outstretched hands across the middle of the field, and he was wide open, and Bill put it right on the money. Great pass right there. And I just said that it looks like to me Derek Pate is going to heat up. He had the momentum. He's real animated on the sideline. He's real hype. He was motivating his team, and he's taking this whole drive. It's been pretty much Derek Pate show.
And he's putting it hard to his whole team, too, Joker.
Most definitely. So we're going to go for the two-point conversion. Hike the ball to give it to Prophet. Just like another penalty.
Something went awry.
And it's like the referee had thrown another flag. I don't know if it's unsportsmanlike. We're going to find out right here. As the Zebras converge.
And really the advantage is to the defensive line, especially with a heavy running team. You know, you can jump and hop off and, you know, the two-point conversion, the worst that happens is a 1.5-yard penalty.
Right, exactly.
Lab, it's going to, you know, kill him. If, you know, at this point, too, with two failed two-point conversions, I don't know that you don't run Javon Ferguson out there and try the extra point. We've seen him make them. You know, right now it's better than what they're doing now, which is nothing. Still no call, Eric.
The referees are still huddling up. And I guess we're going to find out here in a minute what the flags are for.
Yeah, there were more than one.
And I seen one official throw out a late flag. I don't know if it was for a late hit or some extracurricular activity. But we're going to find out here, right?
They're still talking
now,
it over.
Looks like we're going to find out right now. Wow.
Well, the first foul was not that big of a deal. It was encroachment. As I said just a moment ago, ball's the 3-yard line, so that's a 1.5-yard penalty.
Uh-huh.
But another unsportsmanlike conduct call. This is the third one in the game between both teams. And again, now Madison Prep will be kicking it deep. Southern Lab will be kicking it deep into Madison Prep territory. Another penalty.
Do they enforce it on the kickoff or on the 2-point conversion?
Well, no, he just said the latter penalty will be enforced on the kickoff.
Wow.
That's what I think he was about to say. And that's where they have been enforcing them so far.
Wow. He can actually enforce it after the 2-point conversion?
The unsportsmanlike, yeah, that right. Or a personal foul, absolutely.
Wow.
Now, the encroachment's a different story. That's.
So they can actually accept both penalties?
It was a bad pitch. Ball bounced off the ground. Prophet tried to pick it up. But yes, again, we're talking about a personal foul or an unsportsmanlike. Now, if it was an encroachment and. Well, that's a dead ball foul. It's not a good example. Let's say it was two penalties in the course of play. You know, they either accept it or decline it. They don't get that option. But because you're talking about an unsportsmanlike, I believe they're going to march them up on the. We'll find out in a moment. Because they've done the last two unsportsmanlikes.
Well, I think you're right, because it looks like they're lining up at the 40. So we'll find out here. I mean, the kittens is going to kick off from the 45, right?
Well, let's see. Looks like they're...
They're kicking off from the 40.
They're kicking off from the 40s. And, you know, the official stopped just short of saying penalty assessed on the kickoff. Maybe. I'm going to guess. Just a guess here, because high school, some of their rules are a little more convoluted compared to college or the pros. I'm going to take a guess that maybe he had to pick one penalty or the other, and they picked the half the distance, maybe thinking they could punch it in.
Right.
I personally, especially considering the success or lack of success that either side's had on two-point conversions, I'd have taken the 15 yards on the kickoff and pin them deep. But, you know, Jannard Robinson has a pretty strong leg. He ought to be able to get it back there, but they could have really, really, really put the Chargers deep in their own territory as here come the kittens set to kick off. Deep to receiver Savoie and Tyrese Walker for the Chargers.
And we're going to see what the Chargers are going to do. They've been able to answer everything that the kittens have done thus far. The kids go up 6-0, they come back and tie. They go up 12-6, they come back and tie. So let's see if they can come back and make this out of a game.
And there is Walker still on his feet.
Still on his feet, reversed his course. Now he's wrapped up, brought down around the 30.
Oh, took a big one.
Well, he returned it about 15 yards, but he ran about 50.
Great effort on that kid's part. So here come the Madison Prep Chargers. Out for their second possession of the half, actually, of the second half. And they got the ball on the 31-yard line. Down 18-12. It's 5 minutes left in the third quarter, so here we go.
First down, 10 yards to go. Here they come up to the line of scrimmage. Sherrod Brumfield getting the troops in line. Twins left, twins right. The lone setback, I believe that's Quincy Banks. There's the handoff. Banks is on his feet around the right side. I don't think he gained anything on that play.
Another great play by the defensive line of the Kittens. He was able to string him along, and he tried to cut to the outside and maybe gain 1 yard. So they bring up second down. Actually, they gave him 2 yards, so it'll be second down and 8.
Well, they gave him that's a pretty nice spot.
Real good spot for them.
Over here, I didn't think he got anything. Dropping back, fires into the flat. Oh, my goodness. Savoy's wrapped up like a present and dropped. Joseph McWilliams, Johnny on the spot. As Savoy went nowhere, and that pushed them back. I think that pushed them back to the original line of scrimmage.
He saw that all the way. Joseph McWilliams snuffed that play out right from the beginning. It was a wide receiver screen, and he was able to notice it and got right up there before he even catch the ball and was able to get him for a big time loss. Great play. Great open field tackle by Joseph McWilliams.
Third down, 11 yards to go. And we'll see what the Chargers have here to respond. Twins left. Twins right. Lone setback is Banks. Man in motion is Savoy. Brumfield calls for the ball.
He's going to Savoy.
To his right. He fires down the field. He has a man open too much on that one. He had two men open. Both Savoy and Rash were open. But as Rash is limping off the field, actually, and that's going to put a Rash on Coach Roach's hide. As it's fourth down, they're going to be forced to punt as they'll run Braylon Bolden out there again. I believe this is at least his fifth punt this evening.
Yeah, it's about his fifth punt. This evening, I guess he's the calamine lotion, you know, for that rash. That was the first pass. It
took me a second there. Right.
Yeah, but I think that was the first pass I seen him overthrew. He was a little bit anxious. He had two receivers going in the same direction, one under and one over, and he actually overthrew both of them. But it was unfortunate, but the kids get the ball back.
Uh-oh.
And there's a flag. That's 12 in the huddle.
Was it 12?
Wait, listen, I don't know. I think it's delay of game.
I saw the play clock at zero, but...
Delay of game, yes, sir. You got it. So that's going to push them back to the 25. That hurts when you're trying to punt the ball. You cannot afford to give up any more field position when you're punting from that deep. Derek Pates on the Madison Prep side of the field set to return the ball.
And he's itching it. He's ready for him. Yeah, he's itching. I'll kick it away from him.
And that's a knuckleball.
And they tried to. Right, he's going to get it, though.
He outkicked his coverage. Pate has the ball. And, he's hit and dropped. He is flung. WWE style.
Wow.
That's a good tackle. I believe that was Malcolm Roach that got him down. And I'll tell you what, if Roach didn't, he might have gotten some big yards. That was the only pair of hands I saw on Derek Pate.
I know. He was the last line of defense that time. Pate had cut across the field and was getting ready to try to hit the sideline. And here comes Malcolm Roach. Reach out and touch him. And I've seen Malcolm Roach make a couple of big hits tonight. He's a big boy.
Yeah, he's playing
I'm
well.
I'm checking him out. Yeah. He got a sack or two.
He is all over the field on both sides of the ball, but especially on defense.
He's playing defensive end. He's also playing linebacker. He's rushing the passer.
Playing
he's a big guy,
teams,
man.
Yeah. So here we go. There's the pass. Caught complete out there to Kirtland Williams. He's close. I think he's got a first down.
He's going to be close, too. I think he's going to be a little bit short. The ball is placed on the 47, and looks like he's going to be 2 yards short.
Maybe just
a yard.
Yes, at the 48. So that's a 9-yard gain on the play. Second down and a yard to go. Ball is right at the 48-yard line. And there's the handoff, and there's the money man, Darion Prophet. And it's a first down for the Kittens.
First down. Now they're kind of rolling a little bit. Coach Mitchell has... seems to have them with a good strategy here. They're kind of mixing it up a little bit. They'll pass one play, run one play.
So they are in Madison Prep territory, and this could be their first opportunity to take a multi-possession. Ooh, lead. Darby on profit got decked. You can hear the helmets collide all the way up here in the press box.
And here comes another flag.
Yep, that's a helmet-to-helmet. That is the correct call, if that is the call. Yeah, you can hear it up here.
Yeah, you could hear it out here. Look like I see unsportsmanlike conduct. This is about the fourth one I've seen. I don't know if it's on Southern. I see the Madison Prep players clapping their hands, indicating that it's on the on the Kittens. Offense number 55, and what a big penalty by Chad Brown Jr.
That is a silly, silly penalty. They'll be forced to repeat first down. It'll be first and 25. And they were on Madison Prep's side of the field, not anymore. And they were 10 yards away from a first down. That's not the case anymore either. That's a bad penalty.
Another mental error, Eric.
I'll tell you, that's been the story of the night for Southern Lamb.
This is a game where both teams are fighting hard. But at the same time, I think that they're going to have to really tighten up on their mental errors that they make if they want to go down here to New Orleans and play.
Right, you got
to
keep a cool head, because I'll tell you, I've watched Ouachita Christian play. They don't do stuff like that. They play, they run the ball a lot, but I mean, they don't make these kind of mental errors, you know. And if they, either them or St. Mary's, you know, their opponents could capitalize them. These are the kind of things that can cost you a state championship. They have outplayed. In the trenches, they have outplayed Madison Prep.
Yes, they have.
But Madison Prep is only 6 points away. They can take the lead on the next possession because Southern Lab has shot themselves in the foot repeatedly with just unnecessary penalties. You know, it's one thing if your quarterback's under duress and you grab the linebacker and keep him from crushing your guy. That's a good penalty. It's one thing if you get a pass interference in the end zone on a fade route from the 10. Well, that's only going to cost you 5 yards. It's better than 6 points. These unsportsmanlikes and the false starts and the encroachments, those are bad penalties, and they will kill you. So here we are, first and 25. That is not a mistake on your screen at home. Trips to the left, one receiver right. Veal drops back, fires over, caught complete. That's Tevin Abraham, and he is hit hard, but he withstood the first blow. I'll give him credit for that. And so I said Tevin, that's Tevis Abraham. And he's going to gain about 10 yards, so that's going to make second down a lot more manageable.
Yeah, great hit that time, once again, by Mr. Roach. He's playing all over the field.
He's a beast.
Big guy, but Abraham was able to take that licking and keep on ticking.
He has been all over the field. Shotgun for him, a whistle, and there's a flag. Might be an illegal substitution. We'll see what the call is.
I think so. I think the kid was trying to catch the defense with 12 men on the field before he got off the field. And so...
Yep, that's it, illegal substitution. So that's going to move it up 5 yards. That's
great awareness. They needed those 5 yards. It's going to bring up, 3rd and 15 now.
Yep. So they're moving on up like the Jeffersons. They're picking those yards back up slowly but surely. Ball's at midfield. Beal fires one down the field. He has a manhole just over the outstretched arms of Xavier Bell.
Just off his fingertips. Man, what a pass.
Now, this is going to bring up a very interesting situation on fourth down. It's fourth and long. First down play is a low percentage, and they're going to run Jannard. That answers that question. Here comes Robinson out to punt.
Yeah, I was going to say, great call. You don't want to turn the ball over right here on downs and give Madison Prep any type of momentum, especially the ball at midfield.
No,
you're up 6 points. Your defensive line have been playing great. Your defense has been playing good so far. They haven't been shooting themselves in the foot too much.
No.
But this is a great call by Nick Mitchell. I don't know if it's a timeout on the field. It's a minute and 38 seconds left in the third quarter. With the score, the Southern Lab Kittens 18 and the Madison Prep Academy Chargers 12.
And you're watching Southern Lab Kittens football on LouisianaAllAmericanSports.com.
Yeah, boy.
So I'm not sure what the stoppage in play is for. Did the Kittens call a timeout? A little unclear on who called the timeout.
I don't know. Especially by being fourth down, I don't understand why would it be a timeout call right there. It's not a crucial situation.
No.
Unless they, one of the other teams want to get a special teams formation set up.
Or maybe I don't know who called the timeout. I'd be guessing at this point. I'm going to tentatively put the Kittens. I'm going to guess it was them. I don't see why the Chargers would have burned their second time out in this situation. There's a snap. Good snap to Ferguson. A little high. Nice end-over-end kick. It's going to be fielded. Oh, it's going to be fielded. That's Richard. And Everett Richard is dropped, and that's that. So that was actually a very productive play. That's going to put the ball
actually on the 15-yard line.
That's a
great open field tackle. Great special teams play right there by the kids. Great coverage. And so here comes Madison Preps once again. Down 18-12. There's about a minute left in the third quarter, going into the fourth quarter. It'll be first and 10 at the 15-yard line for the Chargers. They got Broomfield in the backfield. Now they got split receivers spread out real, real wide.
And that's interesting. Here comes the man in motion. They're going to drop back to throw. I believe that was Richard in motion. That's Banks around. Oh, man, he just Peter rolled the defender. And I don't know. And here's another flag on the play.
Another flag. Another unsportsmanlike. And they're starting to call this game real, real tight right now.
I don't think they want to see a lot of nonsense. It's getting very, very physical here, Joe.
Yeah, it is very, very physical. And it looks like the kids have an injured player down on the field. Looks to be Deion Rainey.
Yeah, when Rainey tried, I think it was Rainey who tried to make the tackle, and he got just run over.
Yeah, it was either Rainey or McWilliams.
I think that's a nine. Yeah, that's Rainey.
Forrest tried to get the tackle.
I got you. That's one of the first times we've seen Madison Prep really shoot themselves in the foot, and that's exactly what they did. That's a 15-yard penalty, and they've pinned themselves a lot deeper. On the other hand, it's only half the distance to the goal, but timeout for the injured player. So 10 to him. You're right, that might have been McWilliams on the initial tackle. Rainey might have gotten the fallout. He might have gotten rolled up on.
Yeah, I think so. So that's going to hold these guys back, and we've been seeing it on both sides. For this to be a state semifinal, we've been seeing a lot of mental errors that both teams have. Southern a little bit more than Madison Prep.
Right.
But unfortunately, fortunate for them, they have the lead 18-12.
It's like they're helping each other out.
Right, exactly. But Madison Prep actually can't afford at all any mistakes right now.
Yeah, they are in a precarious situation. Balls moved back. They actually moved it to the 9-yard line. And there's the long bomb. And it is caught by Savoy. What a play. And we have seen Sherrod Brumfield just deliver like the mailman over and over and over and over again. And that's going to put the ball into Southern Lab territory. That was a 42-yard bomb from Sherrod Brumfield to Brian Savoy, and Madison Prep now has it in enemy territory. So whatever backing up they had done to the Chargers, that's all the window now, and they're defending their territory. There's the handoff, and that's Spurlock around the right side, still on his feet, and he is wrapped up. He's still on his feet, tiptoeing near about the 35, and there's another flag.
I think that was a late flag. I don't think that was no type of late hit. It wasn't malicious. It was just guy, basically, but they look like they're going to call a late hit out of bounds, which is going to tack on another 15 yards, if I'm seeing it right.
That's
the only thing I
could
see.
Joker,
that's when he right when he threw it.
Oh, boy. They have got to get a hold of themselves. That's Trey Epps. He's a junior. He knows better. He's played a couple of years. And you have got to get a hold of yourself in this situation. You've got to contain your emotions. You do not want to just help your opponent out on the way to the end zone. Just moments ago, Madison Prep was at their own 9, and now they're almost in the red zone.
And I mean, like, really? This is just how fast things can turn around. These guys were pinned back in their own, and they hit a Broomfield with a big play, and now they're trying to score.
End zone, that's not going to make it. Yep, too much on that one.
Too much mustard on that time. Looks like he took a big hit, too.
Oh, man. He's
now Broomfield is laying down on the field.
There's a good news, bad news. If I saw what I think I saw, the bad news is the quarterback is hurt. The good news, although not for him at the moment, I think he got hit in the dunks. And while nobody wants to experience that, the good news is if that's what happened, that's what I think I saw, inadvertent hand down there, he should be able to get back in the game. I know it hurts right now.
I know it hurts right now. I saw him with his hand like he was clutching his knee.
Yeah.
And if he's clutching his knee and
he was hitting the dunk, then he's more of a man than than me. If he had to reach down to his knee in order to grab his crown jewels, then you know, hey, he's blessed.
I'm joking, this is a family show, man. Took me a minute, I'm like, wait a second. Oh, man, and unfortunate. Well, yeah, I'm trying to see what they're working on. It looks like he's favoring the inside, maybe his thigh, his right thigh, or his calf.
That's what I mean. If he's grabbing down there.
Yeah, we got it, Joker. We got it. We got it. We got it. It's a family show.
But hopefully he'll be all right, because he actually came in and relieved the first quarterback, Klein Peter, and that man made some real big plays tonight.
Gives new meaning to let this him all hang let, out.
Right.
Shame. I see you're a bad influence, man. Now, he's walking it off, though, pretty well.
He's walking
I'm thinking
off.
Maybe it's a pull, or maybe he just got just a bruise, like maybe he got hit
right.
in the thigh. And with this
could
weather,
be.
It's exacerbated that much more. So now Madison Prep is reaching deep into the bench for that third-string quarterback. I can't even tell you who that is looking at this roster, so I guess we'll find out.
Looks like it may be Mr. Roach. I see number 11 in the backfield.
There he is. There's Malcolm Roach. Oh, this guy's a triple threat. Offense, defense, special teams. Second down, 10 yards to go. That is Malcolm Roach. Shotgun formation. This is a strange, like a bunch formation. I don't know what to call this. But Roach, he's going to throw the football. He's on his feet. He has nowhere to go. He has nowhere to throw. But he's still going to pick up about 6 yards on the play. 7 yards on the play. Good run. Boy, this Malcolm Roach can do everything. And he's a big dude, too.
He's a big guy. Yeah, he's a real big guy. They played it more conservative right there. But I like the play call until Broomfield comes back in. We're going to see if he's going to come back in on this play. I don't see it yet. Malcolm Roach looks to the sideline. And I think here comes. Is that Broomfield back? I see Malcolm Roach going to the sideline. Looks like they brought in another.
Okay, this is interesting.
Their quarterback. This looks like number 4, Troy James.
Or
is it number 8?
I'm thinking it's probably, I don't know. I do have another.
End of the third quarter.
Information roster. That's the end of the third quarter. Boy, we are set for a really exciting finish here. The score, Southern Lab 18, Madison Prep 12. You're watching Southern Lab Kittens Football on LouisianaAllAmericanSports.com.
Yeah, boy.
Well, I don't know who they're going to pick. I'm looking at the other roster. I don't see a third quarterback on there. So I guess we'll find out momentarily.
We'll find out momentarily. And hey, that took a lot of wind out of those guys for Broomfield to go out. It was having a lot of momentum.
It was
doing pretty good, man.
I mean, really, that's the situation where even though the backup's in the game, he's not your ordinary backup. I mean, he's a guy who probably would otherwise be starting, were it not for the rifle arm Klein Peter.
But it looks like we got a new quarterback, the third string quarterback that's in the game. Actually, going to be the fourth quarterback that they use tonight. They use Mr. Roach, they use Klein Peter, and they use Broomfield. So now it looks like we have Troy James playing a quarterback in a spread formation. He gets the ball out, rolls out, left-handed, throws the ball to the end zone, and incomplete. He had a receiver open, but he couldn't hit him. Ball looks like it was intended for number 31, Radisha Johnson, but he wasn't able to connect with him. So that's going to bring up fourth down now. It's actually fourth down and 4 yards to go. The ball is at the 14-yard line of the Kittens. Broomfield is still on the sideline, injured. Now they have in Everett Reshard as the quarterback. They're in a spread formation, twin receivers on both sides. He hikes the ball. It's a quarterback draw. He spins around, goes to the middle, and the Kittens stop him. Turnover on downs to the Southern Lab Kittens.
Big break
right there. Great defensive stand to start the fourth quarter. But it took a lot of wind out of the sails of the Madison Prep Chargers with their quarterback going down. He had just completed a 49-yard pass to get the ball down to the other end of the field to put themselves in position to try to take the lead or tie the score up, and he went down. And that was very unfortunate for Madison Prep. Kind of killed their momentum.
Southern stood up, defensive line held again, and now they get the ball back. What a chance to try to go up and extend the lead. And here we go. Veal is looking to the sideline for the play call. Three receivers set. Darvion Prophet and Derek Pater's in the backfield with Veal. He's in a shotgun formation. Hands the ball to Darvion Prophet. Hits the sideline. Gets the block. Hits another sideline. Spins. Oh, and flips up into the air and gets the first down all the way out to the 30-yard line.
It's the second time tonight we've seen Prophet go airborne.
Yes, indeed. Hey, he is the man. It looks like we have an injured Charger on the field. Looks like he's going to be number 21. He's grabbing at his knee.
That's Silvante Browder, the senior, down on the field.
And he's patting his stomach out on, and he's patting his right knee. We've had several injuries in the ball game tonight.
It's been a rough, rough,
it's
rough
been a
game.
Rough game. These guys are working hard. Both of them are playing their heart out. They're trying to get to New Orleans in the Superdome for the state championships. Been a very close game. Earlier during the year, Southern Lab Kittens actually blew these guys out 63-6. And from them being able to come back this game and fight hard like they are, down on their third quarterback at that.
They have not gone away.
They
know?
Have not gone away.
But that, I'll tell
on
you.
On the road.
I don't know how long Sherrod Brumfield is out. If it's a short term, it looks like they're stretching him out on the sideline from over here. So, I mean, I would take that to indicate that there's some possibility he may come back in the game. Because if he doesn't, then I don't know where the Chargers are going to get the firepower to come back down the field.
Right, right.
Short of a colossal mistake.
Right. Hey, and the way this game been going, you never know. It's been big play after big play.
U-High, by the way, has won tonight, so they are heading to the Superdome also for the second consecutive year in the finals. They're probably going to face John Curtis. That final score just in
35-13. Wow. Kudos to the U-High.
Yeah, they got some talent on that
they
team.
They got some talent on that team right there, and that's going to be a big game next week.
So here we go again. It's first and 10, and the Kittens are just going to try to push the ball down the throat to the Chargers. And looks like, I believe that's Prophet.
That's Derek Pate.
That's Pate with the football. Okay. Must have been a jet sweep. And they're going to gain.
Got some pretty good yards.
6-yard gain. 7-yard gain. Good run there by Pate.
Great run on first down. And right now, you want to try to take as much time off the clock as you can with the lead. But also, you want to try to be able to put some points on the board. They give the ball to Darvion Prophet to his right side. He got a good block. Gets outside. Gets another first down all the way to the 46-yard line. What a great run by Darvion Prophet that time.
He is just cranking them up, man.
And this is his time right now.
He has been the – I mean, it almost sounds silly to say it, but for those who haven't followed – Southern Lab all playoffs. He has been the MVP of this team in the postseason.
He definitely has been. He had, I think, like a 3 consecutive 200-yard game that we've covered here on LouisianaAllAmericanSportsShow.com.
I dug up some official statistics. That first game he ran for 192 yards. That regular season finale against Kentwood. The other two, he was comfortably over 200 yards.
Wow.
So he has been on a roll. Yeah. 10:41 to go in the game.
Timeout on the field. I don't know exactly who called the timeout. I don't think it would have been the kids. They just got a first down. And just like Madison Prep is over there, the coach is trying to give him one last stand.
And you know,
it seems to me like now his team is starting to wear down a little bit.
And I'm taking a guess at home, folks. I didn't see the official signal. I'm guessing it's Madison Prep, just from everything that you just said. But I tell you, the wisdom of calling that timeout when you're losing, you know, those timeouts are precious. There's no 2-minute warning in high school football. So you only have those 3 timeouts are all you have. Prophet, around the left side, still on his feet. He's into enemy territory. Gain of about 7 on the play. Brings up 2nd and 3.
And this is his time, Eric.
Oh, it is.
Yeah, first down, he's able to move the sticks and get significant yards, getting 6 and 7 yards a pop right now. And that makes the game easier for Southern Lab Kittens. And it makes it easy on their play calling.
He is trying to part that blue sea right now. And he has done so very well so far tonight. Shotgun formation. And Veal hands off to Payton, came out of the backfield yet again.
And there he is. Payton's on the sideline. Here he goes.
And he's run out of bounds around the 33-yard line. Run a run by Derek Payton.
Great run right there. And I like the way they're mixing it up right now. They're running the ball and taking some time off the clock. And they're moving the ball at the same time.
And that clock is just tick, 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 ticking. Ball's at the 34-yard line. That was a 14-yard gain by Payton. They're really pushing more and more and more into Madison Prep Academy territory. Ball's at the 34-yard line, first and 10. Veal drops back to throw into the end zone.
Touchdown! McWilliams.
Kirtland Williams hangs on to the ball, and Southern Lamb has gone up by two possessions for the first time all game. The score, the Southern Lamb Kittens 24, the Madison Prep Academy Chargers 12.
Yeah, boy.
That was a 34-yard bomb from Bladrick Veal to Kirtland Williams. Veal has just been finding folks all night. He has put that ball where it needs to be, when it needs to be there. And now they're coming out to try to extend the lead even further.
Yeah, he's kind of calmed down this second half, Eric. And
he's made some passes.
He's made some great passes. And here he is on a two-point conversion.
Abraham.
And he gets it. Two-point conversion. Good.
It is good. So the score, the Southern Lamb Kittens, that's their first conversion of the night. The Southern Lamb Kittens, 26. The Madison Prep Academy Chargers, 12. You're watching Southern Lamb football on LouisianaAllAmericanSports.com.
Yeah, boy. Great drive right there, Eric. They started out doing everything they wanted to do on first down. They was able to get significant yards by the running backs to be able to have the easier on their play call. And so second down and three, second down and four, they was able to make that call. They gave the ball to Derek Payton on one side. He got significant yards. And just when they thought they was going to keep running the ball, they go with play action and find a receiver, and he puts the ball right on the money.
I don't think they saw that coming.
Exactly. And they just kind of loaned him to sleep with the run from Prophet and Derek Payton. And, man,
boy, Derek
great drive right there.
He's got to be enjoying this as much, if not maybe a little more, than some of his Southern Lab Kittens teammates.
He's had a great game. He's my player of the game so far.
Well, I'll save it for later. I definitely think he's one of them.
Yeah, I like Veal, too.
Yep, that's mine. Now, well, we'll get to that later. We still got a lot of football left.
Yeah, we still got a lot of football left. It's 9 minutes.
9:55.
That's right.
So in this final 10 minutes, the Southern Lamb Kittens have gotten on top of the horse and seized the 14-point lead.
Yeah.
Denard Robinson, nice end-over-end kick. It's fielded by Walker at the 15, and he might lose yards. He's still on his feet. He gained nothing.
Man.
Walker was up to the 18, got pushed backwards, and it'll be first and 10 Madison Prep at their own 15-yard line.
Great momentum, great open field tackle right there. He wasn't able to do anything. So we're going to see how Madison Prep handles just getting scored on with that knock the air wind out of them. But they've been fighting all game. They're down to their third quarterback.
Well, not anymore.
In the fourth quarter.
And, Sherrod Brumfield is back on the field. And in a nick of time, really. Oh, man, they're announcing a Black Friday bundle here at the
Black
Doug Williams
Friday
Stadium.
Special.
Doug Williams Stadium. Black Friday special. Jambalaya, $3. That's a Black Friday bundle right there. And rolling out of the pocket, fires. Oh, that could have been the kiss of death as it was thrown lazily into the flat. And Jannard Robinson was right there, Johnny, on the spot. Fortunately for the Chargers, it was overthrown to Tylan Butler. Might have been on purpose, but had that been a turnover, he'd have housed it, and that would have been it.
That would have definitely been a pick six. Very dangerous pass to throw it out into the flat like that. Luckily, it was overthrown, and neither one could get to the ball, Eric. So
that's another case where, you know, you have a strong quality opponent trading blows with the Kittens, but the Kittens were never knocked out of the driver's seat, and now they are firmly in control of this game as Madison Prep is battling for their playoff lives. Second down, ball's at the 16-yard line, or almost at the 15-and-a-half. Dropping back, hands the handoff to Banks. Banks on his feet, he's got a first down, and he's going to be dropped around the 30-yard line.
Great run that time. Didn't give up. Took the initial hit, was able to bounce off of it,
and continue on and got to end up getting the first down. That was a big, big first down for these guys.
Yeah.
To get some type of momentum going here.
They've got to get something going because they need to score on this possession as we're coming up on 9 minutes to go in the ball game.
This is it right here for them. So it's going to be first and 10 at the 30-yard line.
And Brumfield's being blitzed. He throws long down the field for Savoy. And it's tipped. I believe that's Robinson on the coverage. That was Jannard Robinson again on the coverage. And so that will bring up second down.
Great job right there by the defense that time. I think they called a corner blitz, and Malcolm Hall was in on the quarterback, which made him rush the ball and get rid of it a little bit early.
Well, he did not waste any time putting pressure. And, you know, that was an alert throw by Brumfield to say he got it down the field as far as he did.
And he's actually gimping, man. He's almost playing on one leg. He's walking out there. He can barely move around, but he's their best shot that they have.
There's no tomorrow. There's the draw play, and that's Spurlock, and he's wrapped up and dropped. He actually lost about two on the play. They're going to spot the ball at the 28-yard line, and that brings up third and long.
Yeah, he's limping pretty bad, Eric. And I think from what we saw, when we saw him pass earlier, he was pretty much on the money, cause I guess because he can plant his knee and be able to get the ball. But now it seems like he's, you know, the ball is coming out pretty erratic, and he just kind of throwing it up for grabs. Now.
Totally agree with you, Joker. If you got to go down the field and you can't get that plant foot going, you got a real problem on your hands. Third and long, dropping back under pressure, screen pass, and it's caught. Nate's not going to go very far. Everett Richard actually gains nothing, and I think the Chargers have forced the punt.
And great defensive call. Great defense by Eric Holden for to be able to see that Broomfield is injured. And to put the pressure on him.
Yeah,
go ahead and blitz him.
That's exactly. Take
and
you
that's
got,
what you do.
You smell that blood in the water. You got to get him like
you
a
gotta
shark.
Go, you got to go get him. That's right.
So deep to receive is Derek Fate. And, oh, you want to talk about a shark smelling blood in the water. Anytime you have to kick the ball to him, it could be lights out. We are under 9 minutes remaining. 10 on the play clock. 7:43 actually to go. We're under 8 minutes to play in the game. And this, boy,
and they're electing the kick.
And it's not a good snap. And once again, good job getting it off as it could have been blocked. And they could have scooped it up. But you know what? Go conservative. Why not? Cortland Williams is not the normal kick returner. And they only netted. See, line of scrimmage was at the 28. They're going to spot it at the 42. So that's only a 14-yard net.
14-yard net. Like you said, I'll be more conservative if he was maybe a up lineman or offensive lineman. But he's a wide receiver and defensive back, and he probably could have picked it up and got a little more closer, but hey,
that's
no harm, no foul.
That's the second time tonight that Southern Lab came very close to blocking a punt, and Braylon Bolden, to his credit, just had to, he adjusted the trajectory quickly on the fly to avoid a disaster, but Southern Lab has a chance to put it away. Pate, round the right side, round right tackle, to the 40, 35. He's near the 30. He's going to walk, step out of bounds around the 35 to the 34-yard line.
Great run again right there. The handoff wasn't great, but he was able to pull it in and still get some decent yards, some positive yards out of it.
Really
actually, 8 yards.
Yeah, he picked up a bunch. So it's second and two.
Yeah, another big gain on first down, and that's what you want. Because then second down, you know, you have a variety of plays you can call, and the defense doesn't know whether you're going to pass or run.
And they have got the Chargers guessing at this point. There's no getting around that. Shotgun formation. Veal hands it all. Oh, it's a good play action. Veal around the right side. He had me fooled for a second. Walks up, runs out of bounds at the 30, and that'll be a first and Southern Lab, and that clock's going to keep on ticking into the future, much to the chagrin of the Madison Prep Academy Chargers.
Yeah, 7 minutes, 11 seconds left. He actually could have stayed in bounds.
Yeah, I think he probably needed to be a little more aware, but you know what? I'll take that first
down. I'll take
down.
That. That's right. Good and job right there by Bill.
Southern
Great
Lab is
play.
Inching closer and closer to the Superdome. That game will be next week at 10 o'clock a.m., Friday, December the 5th. Not sure whether or not we'll be bringing that to you live on LouisianaAllAmericanSports.com. There will be some logistics to work out. We will definitely be covering it to you. And worst case scenario, we'll be tweeting you the action live at LouisianaAllAmericanSports.com. You'll be able to follow the graphic interface of the game. We will definitely have live coverage.
how that live coverage will come across, that we don't know yet. There's the handoff. Derek Pate wrapped up like a president, dropped in the backfield. There's a flag. And it might have been a horse collar. I'm not sure. Joker, I must have
missed
something.
It looked good to me.
While I was doing all that talking, how was it? Was it first and 15? Somebody move?
I was first and 15. Southern Lab had a false start.
Oh boy. That
and
cannot continue.
That's right. Right now, it won't hurt him as bad the way that they've been playing, but it's first and 15.
What a silly penalty.
Wow.
They had Derek Pate tackle for a loss, and even if they had, I don't think they had to grab that high. Even if he stayed on his feet, I don't think he would have busted one. But now, 15-yard penalty, that's going to bring up, they're going to repeat the down. It's going to be first and about three at the 22-yard line.
Very costly play right there.
Well, that hurts. That hurts. So, Veal and shotgun. That clock continued to tick. Madison Prep Academy season continuing to tick away like sands through the hourglass. Twins left, one receiver right. Veal has two backs in the backfield. Floats one. Oh, out into the flat. It was a running back screen to Prop, and he couldn't hang on. He started running before he had the ball in his mitts. Six minutes, 44 seconds to go. Brings up second and three.
Second and three, and this could be the dagger. If they can get the ball into the end zone right now with under 7 minutes left to play in the fourth quarter, then, we can get ready to call pressures up here.
Yeah. Yeah, that fat lady.
And here we go. The prophet man. Inside.
To the five, steps out at the four-yard line, and up. That's the fat lady.
Wait a minute. Oh, no.
We can hear her coming down the steps. She's
making
ready.
Her way.
She's not ready. She hasn't started singing yet, but she's getting ready.
She's getting ready. Let me put all the snacks up.
Ba-boom, ba-boom, there she goes. They better put the Chex Mix away. The Twizzlers and anything else, because the fat ladies are coming. And there's a time. And that's Madison Prep. I believe that is their third and final timeout by my count.
I guess they want to try to make one last stance right here, one last defensive stand.
The other thing, too, Tucker, is you got to stop them from bleeding the clock at this point. You're fighting two things, the scoreboard and the clock.
And the clock,
you know,
exactly.
Southern Lab does not need to score to hurt them on this drive, although they're about to, or they're knocking on the door. But even a goal line stand, that's going to run a lot of time off the clock and give Madison Prep no margin for error.
Yeah, they're definitely back against the wall right now. They're definitely under the gun. Because the Southern Lab kids push the ball in here, like I said, those fat ladies are going to come in here as fresh off Thanksgiving. I know, the turkey didn't hold up.
Yeah, that fried turkey's long gone.
Right.
There's nothing but carcass left for soup. First and goal. Ball at the 5-yard line. I formation. Twins to the left. There's the handoff, Javon Ferguson. Boy, he just ran through like a brick through a plate glass window and picked up about 2 yards.
Tried to go with a little power game that time. They brought in the linebacker, Javon Ferguson. They tried maybe like some old Chicago and refrigerator Paris, I think.
Yeah, Ferguson's a jack of all trades. He's the place kicker when they attempt the extra points. And, of course, he's on defense, plays a little defense, and they use him as fullback too. I mean, he's a very versatile athlete.
Well, they got him at fullback here again. It's eye formation.
So, twins to the right this time. One receiver to the left. Veal tries to go fade route. Not a fade.
Dangerous.
Could have let Madison
back
in the game. He tried to find Tevin Abraham. He was open. The ball bounced off Abraham at the goal, and the Chargers defender, I believe that was Everett Richard, almost got a hand in the ball. Joker, if he picks that off, he's gone.
He's picked six.
And it's
and
a
the
one
whole
possession game.
Exactly. I think Coach Nick Mitchell needs, he's been running the ball, stay on the ground. This is
not
the time to make that type of mistake.
And we've seen them fall into that trap before earlier in the season when they hosted Donaldsonville. They really helped Donaldsonville get back in the game by throwing the football when they didn't have to.
Right, exactly.
I formation, McWilliams is the tailback, and that's a Johnny-on-the-spot play as he tried to pitch it to Ferguson. Ball hits the ground, And I'll tell you what, they need to give, you know, the Ohio State Buckeyes put those Buckeyes on the helmet. They need to give Tevin Abraham a little kitten paw, a kitten paw for falling on that ball. That's twice now that they've given Madison Prep an open door. They're in ICU with tubes up their nose, and they're about to come off ICU if the kittens keep this up. This is going to bring up fourth and goal. Ball's at the four-yard line. They did not lose any yards. They're probably going to run the clock down, perhaps burn a timeout, I'm guessing. 5:19.
It's like they're not. It's like they're going to run the play. And they're running the play.
There's the handoff. Mick Williams is stopped cold in his tracks at about the two-yard line. That's going to be a turnover on downs, but a lot of the damage is done as we only have 5 minutes and 9 seconds to go in this ball game with the score. The Southern Lab Kittens, 26. The Madison Prep Academy Chargers, 12. You are watching Southern Lab Kittens football on LouisianaAllAmericanSports.com.
Yeah, boy. Eric, we saw this before. I think at the end of the game, some of the mental errors that Southern Lab has, Kittens have done, some of the play calling has been kind of questionable to me.
Well, definitely the aggressive play calling this late in the game when you have your opponent on the ropes like this. You know, they got to clean some of this up.
They got to clean some of this. Exactly. They got to clean some of this up. You know, because they're going to. And here we go.
And, this is dangerous territory. Was that a forward pass? And a good job. Boy, I'll tell you what. Tyrell Spurlock.
He saved it.
I'm sorry, Kelvin Tyrell. Taiwan Spurlock. There was I think the pass was batted. And so he couldn't throw it far to get rid of it. He caught the ball, and he was in the end zone. He ran literally about a yard away from the back of the end zone and ran all the way to the near side of the field and escaped. That's the most impressive run for a one-yard loss you'll ever see because that saved the game.
That saved the game right there. Actually, it looks like the quarterback couldn't get it out deep, so he checked down to the running back.
Ooh,
I don't know why. Right,
was
in the end zone, which was very, very dangerous. But, hey, that guy was able to make a hell of a play to get it outside the end zone. They got the ball to the one-yard line. And here we go. Broomfield has the ball again. Hikes the ball. Here he goes.
Great defensive coverage because Jaylen Brown, number 9, had a beat on the ball. That was, let's see who that was on the coverage. He's still hunched over.
Yeah, that was Curlin Williams on the coverage. And a great job by Curlin Williams. Like you said, number 9, he had a beat on that ball that time.
That was Williams on the coverage. Okay.
And he didn't interfere, and he was able to get his hands up and knock the ball down. So, big play right there on the defense. Great job.
So this is going to bring up third down. Their whistles. What is this for now? Third and 11. Ball's at the two-yard line.
Is a timeout on the field?
And there, I've got absolutely no idea what they're calling. Third and 11. I don't know what the stoppage was for, Joker. Nonetheless, Madison Prep really has their back against the wall. There's the pass. Overthrows the intended receiver, which was, I believe, number 7. Is that Otis Dumar? No, that was Savoie. Brian Savoie, the intended receiver. And again, even though you've got your back against the wall, you have no choice but to punt. You can't go for it on fourth down here. They've got Madison Prep completely over a barrel right now.
You have no choice but to punt.
4:48 to go, and making matters even worse, you know, we've seen Madison Prep special teams protection been a little questionable. He's not even going to have the full length to fall back. You only have the 10 yards in the end zone plus the 2 up there. You're not going to have the normal 15 yards to come back to snap it. So Braylon Bolden is going to have to get this ball off very, very quickly. Now, we see he has a good leg when he has time, but he hasn't always gotten that. I don't know that you don't send the house. And that's what they do. And
he's
partially blocked. They got to work on that before next year. That has really hurt their cause tremendously tonight. They're going to spot it out at the 21-yard line, so that's only a 19-yard net on
yeah.
that punt.
Yes, sir. It's almost better than going to Derek Pape. He was actually at the 30-yard line waiting on the ball. And so, hey, kudos to the Southern Lab Kittens special team. They were able to go in there. I think that's about the second or third misfire that the Chargers had on special teams. I think earlier they got a 5-yard punt. This time they were able to partially block it.
And they got the ball now at the 21-yard line. They really are. They can go for the throw here. Veal and shotgun. And there's the handoff. Darby on profit. Big hole. He's to about the 12-yard line. And that's just going to keep on rolling up those big yards.
Great job right there. Great job by Darvion Prophet. He still seems to be strong, still has a pep in his step. And I said earlier that it looks like that the charger was wearing down, and you can see it now. The holes are getting a little bit bigger. And so why not just keep running the ball? Don't take a chance by trying to throw a pick six or trying to get too fancy.
Yeah, you don't have to. You've got him. You've got your foot on their throat right now. I mean,
exactly.
Turnovers are the only things that will stop
you. And you can believe one thing. He's not going to. And here we go.
Prophet
around stiff the
arms, too, man.
Stiff around the corner all the way
very
down
close
to the two-yard line. Looks like he went out of bounds.
Good. That looks like where they're going to spot a Joker. So it's another first and goal for the Kittens. As this patient, this Madison Prep Academy Charger patient is in ICU right now. They are 9 feet, 3 yards away from their very impressive season, a breakout year for this Chargers program coming to an end in the state semifinals.
And here they are on three-yard line, split receiver. They get a ball to Prophet.
He's going to lose about three.
Yeah.
They're going to stack him up at the six, brings up second and goal at the six-yard line. We are under 4 minutes to go.
And they're bringing Prophet out. They're going to bring in number three, Pat Green. First time action for tonight. Bring in a fresh bat.
And we've seen Pat. Look, Pat, here's the thing. Just because Pat Green hasn't played much tonight doesn't mean he can't play. We've seen Pat Green run the ball in bursts when he gets the ball.
When he gets the ball, yeah. Another speedy guy.
They've got some weapons on this team. Twins left, twins right.
Veal. Got to go to formation.
Drops back. Plenty of time. Four-man rush. Ball's batted at the line by number 10, Tyrese Walker. Incomplete. And you're right, Joker. I don't.
The same thing happened. It got batted last time.
I don't see it.
Stopping the clock and everything. So I don't understand.
Corey Brownfield, the offensive coordinator for the Kittens, has never been afraid to try new things. And that's great. But when you have this opponent wrapped up like you got them pretty much put away, you don't. My personal opinion, you want that clock to keep running. You don't take chances. Let's suppose another ball got tapped and they housed it, pick six. Now they're back in the game.
Right.
You know, so
just that fast. If I did pass, it would be something like a screen. It would be very, very conservative. It'd be something, you know, it wouldn't be nothing rolling back 7 yards trying to punch it in or fit it in through a window.
And this time they handed off to Pat Green. He might have lost. He did lose about 2 yards in the play. Brings up 3 yards in the play. Brings up fourth and goal at the 9. I agree with you. Maybe Coach Brownfield plays at the high rollers table when he goes to the casino.
Right. He's a gambler. You know what I mean?
He's got a little Kenny Rogers in him.
You got no one to hold him, though. Now, fourth down, I would pass.
What's to lose? The clock will stop either way.
Exactly.
Possession.
And try to score, you know?
Veal drops back, fires a hard one, and you see, right into the end zone. You saw that skipped off fingertips. He had Kirtland Williams. He thought he had him open. Instead, there were three white jerseys. If that's intercepted, and it wasn't, but if it is intercepted,
that's pick six.
There's a lot of green space right there with nobody to stop him. So
and actually, they had a beat on that, but it looked like the their own players bumped into each other and wasn't able to intercept the ball. But you were right there.
The ball was thrown with a lot of velocity too. It would have been a tough one to catch. But the point is, you know, it only takes one play like of that nature to swing the game around. That's a close one. But, hey, that's why I'm just a broadcaster. First and 10. Ball's at the 9-yard line. This is Madison Prep's last gasp. I think even if they're pushed to fourth down, they have to go for it at this point. There are 2 minutes and 36 seconds to go in the ball game.
Oh, yeah.
This is it. And by my count, I believe MPA is out of timeouts. Brumfield's going to take off with it. He's hit near the line. Dorian Welsh, couldn't tackle him. He's still on his feet. Gets the first down. That helps on two levels. That'll stop the clock briefly while the ball is set and give the Chargers a chance to come back up to the line. Ball is at the 13-yard line.
Yeah, they took Broomfield out of the game. So I think he's been pretty banged up. He gave it a go in the second half, and it just couldn't overcome the injury that he had. So
Who's the quarterback? Who's in there?
They got number 8, Everett Richard.
Oh, Richard, okay.
Yeah,
for a hot second. There. Boy, Madison Prep is just about finished. If you can't get the ball down the field, you have no chance of coming back with this little time left.
Twins, and here he comes with the blitz.
Twins left, twins right, and there goes Richard. He's going to hop, skip, jump, slip. Actually, a very good run all the way up to the 24-yard line, but it's a day late. The guy was short.
They made a good showing for themselves tonight, though. I have to give a lot of props, a lot of kudos to the Madison Prep Chargers. They came in here in a hostile environment. They came with fan support. They came and kept the game close. It was 12-12 at halftime. Their quarterback goes down. And if he doesn't go down and gets injured to that point, you know, when he come back a little dinged up, but it kind of affected his performance, I think.
Well, they lost two quarterbacks in this game. I mean, that's a tough.
And who knows?
A bunch of bananas no matter what. Dropping back, Richard, only a four-man rush. He's flushed out to his left, still on his feet, puts one down the field. It bounces off the intended receiver. I believe it's Tyrell Walker.
That's Roach.
That's Roach. Malcolm Roach, the intended receiver. Roach has definitely played a heck of a game, too. A valued effort on his part. He's been all over the field, particularly on defense, with 1:10 to go in the game.
It's actually going to be second down now and 10. I imagine now that they're going to pretty much do whatever they can, see if they can hit a big play real quick, and it's the only hope that they have right now.
The only thing they can do is go down the field.
Right. That's just about it.
That is the only possibility they have left at this point.
That's about it.
So shotgun formation, twins left, twins right. The long setback, I believe. I can't get the number there. Richard's going to step up in the pocket, throws up a duck. That is intercepted by Joseph McWilliams, who's also played an outstanding job on defense. Still on his feet. All you got to do is get to the ground, and he does, and that's going to do it. And time of death, 54 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter. That's probably one of the latest times we've called here on LouisianaAllAmericanSports.com when we've covered the Southern Lab Kittens. But nonetheless, that will seal it. The Kittens are heading on to New Orleans next week to face the winner of St. Mary's and Oshawa Christian next Friday, December the 5th at 10 a.m. in the Louisiana Superdome.
Turn out the lights, the party's over. They say that all good things must end. Call it a night. The party's over. Until tomorrow starts the same old thing again. And that will do it here from Doug Williams Stadium in the final minute. Southern Lab has called their second timeout. They have one remaining. And I'm really wondering what they're calling it for. They're saying don't act like a jackass. I don't know after the game is over. I'm not clear. But because this one's over.
Yeah, this one's over. I got Della Reese at my door. You know. If she wants to sing, baby.
Well, you better watch some of Della Reese. Your ghost will come back and shoot a hole in your pinky toe.
Yes, indeed. Great job.
Now I got to cut you.
Ooh, you want to hit people with garbage cans.
Now I got to cut you.
And there they go. They're in the lab kids in victory formation. They need to kneel down on the ball. One more kneel down. That looks like that's going to be it, Eric. And they're on their way to New Orleans for the second time in a row.
Last year they lost. They lost in the semifinals to St. Frederick, who they delivered a return favor to last week. And now Oshawa Christian, I'm trying to get the score in that game right now, see if that one is over yet. But should Oshawa Christian win that game, they're going to have some revenge on their minds, too, and it is Oshawa Christian. The Southern Lab Kittens will play Oshawa Christian next week. Oshawa Christian was the team that the Kittens unseated in the state quarterfinals to advance to the semifinals, and they will face Oshawa Christian again in the Superdome next week at 10 a.m., and we will be bringing some coverage to you of that game on LouisianaAllAmericanSports.com.
Yeah, boys.
So, Joker, I guess any parting shots? I think for me, my offensive player of the game is Bladrick Veal. Defensive player of the game is Joseph McWilliams. For Madison Prep, I guess their honorable mention, if you will, offensive player I'm going to say is Sherrod Brumfield, a great effort, a valiant effort and a losing effort, and Malcolm Roach on defense.
I second exactly what you said. I was going back and forth between Derek Payton and Bladrick Veal, but I think I'll give it to Bladrick Veal because he played a really composed game. He started out a little bit rattled. His pass was a little bit over, but hey, he calmed down, settled down, and got himself in there and was able to drive this team down when they actually needed to get inside the end zone. He was able to make two big drives and be able to put these guys away.
You know, I'm really impressed just watching the Southern Lab Kitten team
grow from this, literally this very seat last year on this side of the field, as they had the floor mopped with them by U High, and they continued to develop throughout the year, and now here they are on their way to the Superdome, one win away from a state championship, as they will cross blades again with Ouachita Christian, the very team that they rubbed out, a team that last year in that quarterfinal game had won over 20 consecutive games at home, and Southern Laird broke that streak in a very close game that literally came down to the final play. They will have that opportunity again. You know, this is kind of a bittersweet moment for me personally, and for LouisianaAllAmericanSports.com. There would be no LouisianaAllAmericanSports.com were it not for Madison Prep Academy. This was where it all began. Louisiana All-American Sports began as an experiment to broadcast high school sports of smaller schools. You know, not the big dogs, not the ones that Cox Sports are showing, although we've been in the same room as those guys now.
Right.
And started off with the Madison Prep football team, which was a Class B team, basically the equivalent of a junior varsity team. And it has grown. We've brought you state championships. We brought you the Madison Prep state championship last year. And now we're becoming, you know, one of the go-to deliverers of content for high school sports for teams in the Baton Rouge area, and you know, I'll always have a place in my heart for Madison Prep Academy. That was our launching point here, and now we'll be covering the state championship next week here on LouisianaAllAmericanSports.com.
Yeah, boy.
So for Joker Pete, this is Eric Hatfield. We will see you next week. Good night on Louisiana All-American Sports. Join in next Saturday, Friday morning, 10 a.m. Join us tomorrow morning on 96.9 FM, WHYR, at 11 o'clock for the Louisiana All-American Sports Show, or anywhere worldwide at WHYR.org. For Gerard Piper, this is Eric Hatfield. Good night. See if you can catch either Coach or Veal or
There you go, Cole.
Oh, yeah. Right on, right on.
Oh, there you go.
Right on.
Right on.
Right now, y'all sound just like the children when they cross that red sea. First, I'm going to say congratulations. Next, y'all played together as one in face of adversity. When it looked dark, y'all pulled together. Y'all played together tonight like champions do, like true champions. In the midst of whatever may go on, when it get bad, tonight y'all pulled together. Adversity came, y'all faced it. Y'all stood up to it and y'all came through it. Congratulations on everything that y'all have accomplished this far. But we got one more game. One more game. So we can do like they always say. You can celebrate for the next however long coach give you. And then that's it. We go back to work.
Back to the grind.
I told you before tonight, I'm going to let y'all know how I feel about this band. God gave this band a vision. Just like he gave Moses a vision. Children, they fought in tooth and nail. But they came together. Tonight he's our Moses. God has given him that vision, and all we got to do is just keep going with that vision that God has given us. We're not through yet, gentlemen. Not through yet. And Red Sea was a little rough tonight. When he had to party, we did what God told him to do. But tonight, y'all came together as true champions, together as men. But we still got one more to go. The promised land is right there. Right there. And God has got it waiting on you. All you got to do is just hold on for a little while longer. Keep believing. Keep staying together as one. Stay in that boat as we talked about. Stay together and we'll have that promised land. One more week of work. And that promised land is sitting right there for you. But congratulations for tonight.
All right. Real quick, guys. I'm not gonna keep you long, but I'm going to just say this, okay? 4 years ago, when I got here to Southern Lab, I had a vision before I got here. And when I got that vision from God, he gave me everything that I needed. He gave me great football players. He gave me great coaches. And he gave me a great institution from which to build that championship right back from the ground up to get where we needed to be. And in those years that we've been here, we've gone through a lot together, man. You guys have been stubborn at times. You've been excited at times. You've done what we've asked you to do sometimes. Sometimes you haven't. But the bottom line is you stuck with it, man. You stuck with us and you stuck with me. And I can't tell you how much I appreciate you guys buying into the vision. All those days that we had to work, those Januaries and Februaries where we were in that little iron hole, lifting weights, maxing out, going up and down those bleachers, going around that track, going to Living Waters, buying in to the preseason camp, buying into the schedule that we put together to make you into iron sharpened warriors. And you bought into it, man. You didn't complain about it. You just did what we asked you to do. And I can't be more proud of the fact that you did that, and I can't be more proud to be your coach tonight. And I'm gonna tell you something. We're playing against Ouachita Christian. It's tied 1-1. They licked us once, we licked them once. Difference is, now we get to play them in front of 30,000 people in the Superdome. Now, here's what I'm gonna say. This is gonna be brand new for everybody in here, okay? It's gonna be brand new. It's a new normal. We talked about the new normal last year. This is a new normal for Southern Lab football. 3 years in a row, we practiced on Thanksgiving. 2 years out of those 3 years, we came up short. This week, we practiced on Thanksgiving, and we finished the fight. We crossed the bridge. And now we get to that destination, which is New Orleans. You got one more fight left, man. You got 48 minutes that'll determine the rest of your life as a football player. And if you can't get 48 minutes in the Superdome, you can't get 48 minutes at all. So let's be prepared for what's about to happen. And let's be sharpened and be focused on the things that we need to do to finish this fight. Now, I got something for you when we get back to school. I've been holding on to these sweatshirt hoodies for 2 years now. I was waiting for the right moment to give them to you. Well, guess what? Now I'm going to give them to you because we're going to wear them together as a team in New Orleans. Yeah.